Still average 1-1.
Play is on, and we'll note that Bobby Taylor and I have been paid and selected by Prism TV. Back behind the net is Jay Welch, who's out with veteran Jerry Korab, and up front, they have Kelly on the left with Ruskowski picked up earlier in the season from the Chicago Blackhawks. And the other forward is Jim Fox, who has the puck at center. It's tapped back by Cochran into the Los Angeles zone to our right. Cochran out with Howe, and they have Carson on with Clark and Allison. Here come the Kings breaking up at center right. Ruskowski down that right wing side into the right wing corner, carrying the puck, looks to dump it back to the point, and then Korab fires it behind the net for J.P. Kelly. He's skated off by Howe, wraps it back to the right point. Korab clears it right back down behind the Philadelphia net. Kelly tied up by Howe, gets it to Fox, offensive left wing corner. He's grabbed by Cochran. Halfway up on the near side, Allison goes, and then it's taken away by Clark. Wound around to the left wing corner, defensively behind the net to the Flyers, who have had trouble getting out of the corner. Now they get it up, throw on a breakaway. Clark in and all alone. He fakes the shot. He's pulled down inside of the net. A shot there by Carson. And no penalty call on the drag down of Clark, who's still behind the net. Up ice come the Kings. They play into the corner to Jay Wells. Looks for the trailer. He drives an impossible angle shot from the right boards. It ricochets back to the point. We're trying to keep it in as Marcel Dion is out there with Danny Bonner, former teammate of Philadelphia's Brian Tropp and Allison and Brad McTiernan. And then as he's challenged in his own right wing corner, the Flyers flip it out of the rink. Mark Howe, the challenge by Dion. We get a stoppage of play. 1:25 gone on the scoreless first period.
Well, I'll tell you, we've had a couple of close calls. One by Clark as he was taken away without a real good shot away, and the rebound came to Carson. And Mattson, sprawling to his right, was able to come up with a save and kept this game scoreless in the opening few minutes. Dave Taylor and Steve Bozek scratch for the Kings. Bobby Froese and Tom Gorens for the Flyers.
Flyers win the draw. It's Sittler out along with Barber and Sinisalo, and facing them is Bonner with Charlie Simmer and Marcel Dion. Kings headbanded all the way behind the Philadelphia, and that should be an icing if Philadelphia gets there first. And they wave it off, and Dvorak loses the puck. Left wing corner, Bonner tries to go back to the point. Taken away, and Sinisalo skates free at center ice. Down that left wing side, flips into the Kings zone. It ricochets around behind Mattson to the Kings defensive left wing corner, where Dion gets it through on the near side, trying to come out and unable to do so is Charlie Simmer. And the Flyers get it to Sittler, who flips from the right boards at center in along the right side of Mattson. Sets it up for Dean Kennedy, who was recently involved in a tissle, if we can call it that, with Kenny Lindstrom. Bobby will talk about now. The Kings over the line. Open man in front. High shot in on Lindbergh from the right wing is grabbed off the stick of Dion for the stoppage of play. From the Forum late afternoon, we have 2:08 gone in the first period, and there is no score.
You want something better, only food that's good and fresh. Wendy's does it better for you, there's nothing less than Wendy's. Fresh ground beef, hamburgers, better you can't find. They're made and cooked and served up fresh, they're not the frozen kind. That's why you're Wendy's kind of people. You want something better, you're Wendy's kind of people.
We'll have play on here in the Flyer defensive left wing circle. Plockhart out with Prop and Holmgren. Bave back defensively with McCrimmon as Dean Hopkins is taken down behind the Philadelphia net by the Flyers' Frank Bave. We get another standoff and another Kings offensive right circle. Nope, they're going to call it in center ice as Hopkins fell on the puck offensively to kill play.
Pretty good speed here in the opening few minutes. I would think that McCammon would try to get as many line changes earlier in the game, somewhat similar to what he did in Winnipeg, to make sure everybody gets in the game right at the start.
Lockhart wins the drop to Holmgren, flips it past Darrell Evans behind the Kings net. Cleared by Larry Murphy, who's bumped by Holmgren. Off to the far side, and Hopkins flips to center ice. Bave tries to go back in and does pass Holmgren. Retrieving is Larry Murphy behind the Los Angeles net. Swings out to the left side of Mattson, outlets it into center ice, but right onto the stick of Philadelphia's Prop. Back to McCrimmon and off the skate of Holmgren at center ice, but a nice sweep check by Frank Bave stops the Kings rush up ice. Flyers come to center ice, and it's again dumped in behind the net. Poor block hard by Holmgren, but digging it out and working it up on the near side is Larry Murphy. Murphy through to center ice, but unable to control the puck is Doug Smith, another high draft pick in recent years of the Kings. Kings take it back into the zone. They're going to get a play, but then a drop pass to Darrell Evans for an inexplicable reason from Doug Smith, who had a wide open shot from the right circle. Then the Kings' Korab fires from center ice in on the Philadelphia net. Cleared by Lindbergh off on the far side, and Mark Taylor is out there now along with Evans and Wilson. Can't get anything going for the Flyers. Up ice now comes the Kings at the Flyer line. A wind-up shot into the breadbasket of Philadelphia's Pelle Lindbergh by Bernie Nichols. The Flyers seeing him for the first time, a high scorer coming up late last year and early this year till he was hurt.
He injured his knee, and it was out much of the season as you... Nichols came across the blue line, really had nothing to, nowhere to go as the Flyers had it pretty well cut off, and that long shot was taken rather easily by Lindbergh. Wanted to make sure that the rebound wasn't given away in any dangerous situation, he just hung on for the faceoff.
Nichols, Mike Murphy on the right, along with Wolf Isaacson on the left. Defensively, they have Wells along with Korab. The Flyers win the draw. Cochran out with Howe, and up front again, Wilson along with Taylor, who carries out on an outlet pass at center ice at the Kings line. Backhands it in on Mattson, right out in front, the loose rebound, but he's able to poke it around behind the net as Ben Wilson was cut off by some good screening from the checker, Nichols. Kings shoot at the center ice. Cochran cuts it off, and then Evans, as he tries to wheel right, hauls the puck loose in the Kings zone, sent by Korab up on the right wing at center ice to Mike Murphy. Flips cross ice into the near corner of the Philadelphia zone, where Howe tries to clear it out. It's picked off in the corner by Isaacson. Now Howe is double-teamed. The Flyers get it back around behind the net up on the left wing for Evans. He stopped, and it's poked by Cochran off the stick to center ice, and then cleared. Through, over the line, comes... Wilson then, and Taylor tried to do a little pivot to send it in on Wilson, but it's behind the net. Ben has no help as the Flyers making a line change, and it's taken off by Mike Murphy. Tries to get it up, ice through into the neutral zone, where it's poked to the Flyer line into the zone, but Isaacson couldn't reach him, and the Flyers cutting across the Flyers to center ice. Now the Clark line is out there as it comes back to in the neutral zone for Dvorak. Fires on Mattson, steers off to his right. You've just joined us. We have live afternoon hockey from Los Angeles with 4.5 minutes gone first period. There's no score. The Kings have both shots. There have been no penalties. Puck given away by Los Angeles at center ice. Played through by Dvorak looking for Carson. That'll be an icing as it goes over the Flyer goal line. Touched up by Dean Kennedy for the stoppage of play.
Hey, don't miss the next Flyers Youth Hockey Clinic. Join Ben Wilson, Ilkka Sinisalo, and Jim Watson on February the 15th. That's a Tuesday night at 3:30 to 5:30 at the Tarkin Rink, in Northeast Philadelphia. If you want more information, contact the Flyers office, and their number is 215-465-4500. That's February the 15th on a Tuesday night.
Clark, Allison, and Carson out, along with Dvorak and Marsh, and the Kings counter with Fox, Ruskowski, and J.P. Kelly. Philadelphia wins the draw. Outlet to Ray Allison at center. Fires it off the defenseman, Jay Wells, a stick behind the net. Make that Mark Hardy. Retrieved by Dean Kennedy, and as he tries to dump it, it's poked away by Philadelphia right side. Allison tried to go in deep for Carson. Three Flyers along the near side. They roll it toward the net. Cut off nicely by Mark Hardy and up through to Kennedy net center ice, where it's carried at the Flyer line and flipped in by Jim Fox. In there first is J.P. Kelly, but it's cleared away to the near side and taken by Philadelphia's Mark up the middle of the ice on the right side to Clark. Through at the Kings line. Marsh stops. Clark threw him a pass picked off by the Kings. They work up on the right side. Fox over the line into the zone. Drops a pass. Gets a return around behind the net. Angle shot off the blocker of Lindbergh and sent through by... We've got a 2-on-1. Barber going all the way in with Sittler. There's a pass. Shot. Oh, rebound over the top of the net. Oh, my. As Brad McCrimmon went in on an open net rebound after Sittler, and Barber sort of fumbled the play and had an open net. Missed it as the Kings shoot it all the way down and we'll have an icing call. 5:51 gone in the first period from the Forum in Los Angeles. No score.
I just moved my money market fund to PSFS, the biggest bank in the area. The new PSFS money market account is safer and easier. Safer because it's insured by the FDIC. Easier because PSFS lets me get my money in cash when I want it. Yeah, I'm glad I moved. Market fund to PSFS, because now, more than ever, I can't afford to take chances.
We can help you make it.
Well, the Flyers had the best opportunity, didn't capitalize. 5:51 gone, first period from the Forum. in Southern California. Flyers have Sittler, Barber, and Sinisalo out from the Crimin and Bays, and it is Jay Wells on defensively for the Kings, along with Korab. As the Kings shoot it all the way down, Lindbergh will have to set it up behind the net. Picked off by Brad. Given away on the near. Offensive left wing corner for the Kings. Drive in on the net by Dion is wide of the net. The Simmer was right there looking for a rebound. And the Flyers quickly come. Sittler to center ice. 2-on-4. Right winging a pass, but it's behind Sinisalo. And as he drags it into the zone, he's offside. With 6:13 gone in a scoreless first period, Flyers. Till next Thursday when they come home against St. Louis.
Well, most of them are off. Daryl Sittler and Kelly Lindbergh and Mark Howe will be in the All-Star game Tuesday night at the Island.
All right, Flockhart on with Holmgren and Propp. Defensively, Cochran and Howe. Korab out with Wells, and up front they have Dion with Simmer and Bonner. Behind his own net, boom, the Kings defenseman Wells was taken off, but they get it up through to Dion from Simmer. A return pass to Charlie at the flyer line. Chris crossing with Bonner up the middle. He's in. Shot. And Lindbergh steered that off to his right. That shot emanating from the top of the right circle. Flyers have had just that one thrust down ice as they're just a little sluggish. But again, they've only played one game since last Saturday at Minnesota. And that was not a hard game for them against Winnipeg. So they may have some rust, and they'll have to play themselves out of that rust. Now Howe, as he went behind the net, missed the check on Jay Wells as the Kings work it up on the left side. Charlie Simmer, not a good skater, lumbers into the neutral zone over the red line, fires it down behind Lindbergh, and it rolls past Kelly up on the Flyer defensive left wing side for Propp. Gives it at the Flyer blue line. He gets a return pass from Cochran, up through to Flockhart, tips it into the zone, but it's cleared away nicely by Dean Hopkins. Then Howe hits Hopkins, who takes the puck down that right circle. Drive over the top of the net to the near glass, overskated by Darrell Evans, kicks it into the offensive left wing corner, spins away from the check, gets it to the point, shot on this time by Hardy, and it's grabbed on the rebound off the near side of Lindbergh by Ben Wilson, and the Flyers get it up on the right side at center ice to Propp. All by himself, drives it in on Matson, who's had very little to worry about, except that two-on-one developed on a three-on-one for Philadelphia. There's a steal, Evans can't find the handle, here come the Kings. Over the line, Dutch Smith fakes on Marsh, loses it into the offensive right corner. He's tied up, as is the other checker by Philadelphia's Ben Wilson, and here come the Flyers up at center ice. Mark Taylor along with Marsh and Evans at the line, through to Marsh, going right on in, shot, oh, and Lynn and Matson on that two-on-one with Marsh going in all alone, got the skate on the right side to keep it away, and here come the Kings. Dean Hopkins at center ice, works into over the line to Doug Smith. Flyers take it away and break 2-on-3 at center ice as the Kings in a line change. Boy, there was Dave Lewis really burying the Flyers at center ice, and we get the puck in along the near side as Allison was really clipped by Dave Lewis, who made that run from the other side of the ice. Now Evans is in there along with Mark Taylor, and they take a run in turn at Doug Smith and Larry Murphy as we have 8:20 gone first period, no score, and that will get the Flyers going.
Well, right now, Taylor and Lewis are having a few words with each other in front of the net. I'm sure that Hogarth blew that whistle quickly because they did not want to have anything happen in the corner, but Taylor was trying to get control of the puck, and Lewis got him with a real solid body check. Knocked him down. But prior to that, Mark Howe was gotten, Wells got a piece of Howe, a solid piece, knocking him into the boards, and that was just a play previous to that. So the Kings are hitting this afternoon.
Clark, Allison, and Carson with Babe and McCrimmon. Offensive right circle, it's the Ruskowski line out with J.P. Kelly and Jim Fox. Point shot by McCrimmon, and Matson goes down to block it off. The Kings wind it around to the right side. And Fox with nowhere to go, clears it behind, puts himself in a little trouble. Flyers break the puck free. Out of the near side, it's taken by Allison. Knocked down in front, Clark a shot. Save, and it goes through the prone body of Allison along the near side. He takes down Dave Lewis as the Flyers getting aggressive, but Ruskowski works it out to Larry Murphy, who will carry unchallenged to center ice. Puts it on the stick of Ruskowski at the Flyer line. Penetrating down that right wing side. Puck poked away nicely by Babe and cleared by Philadelphia's Lindsey Carson to center ice. Dave Lewis, the captain of the Kings, waits for his line to clear, drives it behind Lindbergh. Set up for Babe. Cleared, but not out on the far side by Lindsey Carson. Whacked at by Dave Lewis. And Carson has it again and through past Allison into center ice. And the Kings, Jay Wells has it. To Larry Murphy along the near side. Lifts it into J.T. Kelly. He skated off the puck in the zone. Crossed into the slot for Ruskowski by Jim Fox. Passes awry, taken by Ray Allison to the Flyers and cleared out. Now the Kings come back in offside, though, as Jim Fox on the right wing, as J.P. Kelly, his line mate, went in a stride too soon. 9:20 gone first period. No score, no penalties, and the shots even at six.
Well, you know, Gene, we have an awful lot of transplanted Philadelphians out here in Los Angeles, and we have one working on our broadcast today, Lynn Hill, and she wants to say hello to everybody back in Ambler, Pennsylvania. So everybody in the Hill family, Lynn says to say hello.
All right, we've got Dion out with Simmer and Danny Bonner, who wore number 8 in his other tour of duty up here, but now is wearing the odd number of 44. Cochran, as he tried to go to Howe, flubbed the pass, and then Mark had to take it, shoot it all the way down. Rolls over the Philadelphia goal line. In pursuit is Jerry Korab, and we have an icing call, Philadelphia.
Well, right now, the Flyers appear to be a little bit sluggish. They haven't got their transition game down as effectively as they did in the second and third period in Winnipeg. And again, I think you hit it right on the head, Gene. It's going to take them a while to get back that game conditions of not playing only two games in a matter of a week, this being the third. 6-6, the shots on goal. And Los Angeles are playing a very conservative style game. I think they're just only sending the one man in, but making sure that they pinch off the boards.
Simmer will take the draw with Dion in the trigger position, top of the offensive right wing circle, but that plan doesn't work as the Flyers quickly gets it to Barber, and Barber lifts it in the air into center ice. It bounces to the Kings line into their zone along the near wing, where Jay Welch puts it to Simmer. Simmer looking for Bonner on his right at the Flyer line, flips in left for Dion. Dion in there with Mark Howe. They collide. They'll be two participants in Tuesday's All-Star game, one for each conference, but tied up behind the Philadelphia net. Cochran tied up by Simmer, and Dion in turn by Philadelphia's Mark Howe.
Well, Dion again on top of the scoring parade for this Los Angeles Kings, and I would think they keep saying that he's improving his play in both ends of the ice over the last couple of years, and I know playing for Don Perry, you're going to have to play both ends.
Defensive right circle faceoff, Philadelphia's Darryl Sittler against Marcel Dion. There's another participant for Philadelphia Tuesday, Nassau County. Flyers along the near side, chips the point, and Sinisalo fails to get out. Jay Welch goes in left wing corner, takes the shot, fans, gets it, tries to go back to the point, does, Korab a shot. That's deflected to the left of Lindbergh. Kings try to get it. Oh, Simmer all alone in front, but the Flyers get the puck up on the near side to Sinisalo. Crosses to Sittler, who carries it through at center, then has trouble handling it. Rolls the puck through at the Kings line, where Korab puts it on Dion's stick. Up on the right side, it's carried by Bonner. Winds it around behind Lindbergh to the near side, where Simmer works with Mark Howe, and the Flyers send a Sallow. And again, the Flyers are not really playing an alert brand of hockey. They lose the puck at center ice, as if they're trying to reconstruct. Now let's see, just how do we do this game? Mark Howe bringing it up in the center. Throw at the Flyer line, but poke checking it into the side seats off the stick is defenseman Dean Kennedy. 10:36 gone from the Forum in Inglewood, California. First period, no score.
TV. Check. Cosmic Arc cartridge.
Check. Power.
We have power.
Cosmic Arc is a game cartridge for the Atari video system.
Meteor! I got it!
The Cosmic Arc searches out strange creatures on distant planets.
Beam them up!
But the deeper the Arc travels in space, the tougher it gets.
We may never get back to Earth!
Boys, clean your room.
We're back.
Cosmic Arc by Imagic.
Vicaro's Video, Reading, Pennsylvania. Video connection available at New Jersey.
Gene Hart along with Bobby Taylor back at the Forum in Inglewood, California. No score, 9:20 remaining first period. No penalties, the shots even at 6. Very cautiously played first period. Flyers had the best opportunity in a 2-on-1 Sittler-Barber break. Failed to score. Now Philadelphia has it along the right wing. Prop is there, shot! Right in front, the rebound. He tries to go over, knocks in, it rolls to the open side of the net. We get a stoppage of play, and Ron Hogarth, I think, just lost the side of puck when it appeared it might have been a penalty call. So all that comes out of that is an offensive right circle faceoff.
What happened is that he is really blowing that whistle quickly. It was a shot by Pratt, and Mattson kept the rebound in front of him and off to the side, and then as he Pratt tried to get it up over him, it hit him in the chest and rolled to the right side. But that's when Hogarth thought he had covered the puck.
Right, Flyers has Flockhart out with Holmgren and Pratt with Dvorak and Marsh. The Kings work on that far side but can't get out. They've got Dean Hopkins out there along with Doug Smith at center and Darrell Evans along the near wing. They do get it to center, but Smith is cut off by Dvorak, and Flockhart pinned along the right boards at center ice, can't do anything, and then it's lifted by Dvorak, offensive left corner. Dean Kennedy there, poke checked away by Prop along the boards, offensive left side to the point, shot on the net off the chip by Philadelphia's Flockhart, that's wide, wound around to the Kings' defensive right side, trying to come out as Dean Hopkins, he stopped. Prop, after he takes a bump from Dean Kennedy, shoots it behind the Kings' net. There's a check on Mark Hardy by Holmgren, and for the first time, the Flyers have asserted themselves, and the Kings say enough of that and shoot it out of the rink to recoup and regather forces. 21 remaining in the first period from the Forum in Inglewood, California. The Los Angeles and the Kings and the Flyers are scoreless.
Avalon Supreme Motor Oil. Up front, its protective additives help save wear and tear on your engine. And in back, its special friction fighter helps save on gasoline. It takes proven upfront engine protection backed by improved gasoline economy and puts them all together.
Get a knit hat free with a Havilland oil change filter and lube. Get a matching scarf at a special price. Good only until February 28th at your participating independent Texaco retailer. Bernie Nichols out for Los Angeles along with Mike Murphy and Ulf Isaacson. And the Flyers counter with Taylor, Evans, and Wilson. Point shot by Bay deflects off the body of Mike Murphy to center ice. Brad McCrimmon does some mark timing until the Flyers clear. And then as it's dumped in by Ben Wilson, Dave Lewis has been the big bombing culprit body-wise for the Kings. Takes Ben out as the Flyers chase the puck behind the Los Angeles net. Given off to Mike Murphy from Dave Lewis, and he just rolls it into center ice. Brad McCrimmon there, back passes to Wilson, as it hit him in the skate, and gives it away to Bernie Nichols at center ice. Nichols has to rag, waiting for Mike Murphy to come out, and then backhands a weak one. It dribbles in on Lindbergh, bounces over the stick, and that's why it's always good to have the pads here. Flyers give it away, going right on in is Larry Murphy, shot! And Lindbergh erased that careless play by Philadelphia, getting that one away from the net, as Murphy penetrated from the point all the way in on net. Right circle pass to Murphy again, drive blocked off by Frank Bave, as the Flyers now see the Kings put a little heat on, and Bave gets it through to Paul Evans at center ice with Wilson on his left. The trailer is Mark Taylor over the line. Evans is run into by the defenseman who loses his stick. That's Bernie Nichols, and the Flyers lose possession of the puck. 7:15 remaining first period as Captain Dave Lewis of the Kings just ices it. It goes wide of the Philadelphia net, and the Kings will suffer the violation as Mark Howe touches up with 7:07 remaining first period. No score, no penalties. 8-7 the shots, Philadelphia.
Mark Howe, one of the top plus-minus players in the league right now, starting out at the top of this trip, he was a plus 30, which is an excellent plus-minus. And those are the figures, really, that an awful lot of the players really look at, because it really shows you the worth that man is when he's on the ice for Philadelphia.
Ruskowski, Fox, and Kelly against Allison, Carson, and Clark, but Howe and Cochran, the Flyer defense. And for Los Angeles, it's Jay Wells out with Korab. Howe going deep in the offensive corner as Clark still capped by Ruskowski. Flyers dig it out. Allison rolls it behind the Los Angeles net. Only player there is Los Angeles' Korab. He loses it in his own right wing corner, has to come around near side for Jay Wells. Wells' pass out is blocked by Ray Allison, then he ices it. As the Kings, Don Perry is obviously saying, when you get in trouble, get it out. And that's just what they do for another icing with 6:42 remaining in the first period. Kings and Flyers are scoreless.
1902, when the Wright brothers were still making bicycles, Rosenbluth already had 10 years of experience in travel. Today, with more than 90 years of travel experience, more people count on Rosenbluth than anyone else in the Delaware Valley. They count on Rosenbluth to help them fly Olympic Airways with new low fares to Greece, daily nonstop 747s, and spectacular Greek island fly cruise or private yacht packages. And while anyone can put you on an Olympic flight, only Rosenbluth lets you travel with more than 90 years of experience.
Offensive right circle faceoff here at the Forum in California. Flyers and the Kings. Philadelphia's Clark against Terry Ruskowski. Flyers in the attack zone. They've had one good opportunity in on Madsen. Kings have really not had the big play except for Murphy's close in drive moments ago. Flyers win the draw, but then give it away, and Korab outlets it on the right side at center ice for Jim Fox. Crew dumping it offensive left wing corner. J.P. Kelly is impeded on his way in by Allison, allowing Howe to work up the middle and play the puck off Clark's stick to center ice along the far wing. And then Korab gives it away to Ray Allison on the near side. Takes a bump from Wells, but Clark in the zone avoids the bump from Korab, wants to go cross ice. Cochran off the board, drives to the net! And two Philadelphia Flyers got a tip on it, and we're going to get a penalty. And it looks like it's going to be Jay Wells for pulling down Lindsey Carson. First penalty of the game at 13:50 of the period. Flyer power play coming up, and there is no score.
Don't forget Thursday night's game against the St. Louis Blues next Thursday. You can get tickets for that by phoning 665-8051 or 800-223-0120. Lindsey Carson was charging for the net, and as he was trying to pick up that rebound or a possible deflection, that's when Wales tripped him up. Time of the penalty, 15:50, and the first power play will go to Philadelphia.
For Wells, 113 penalty minutes on the year. And the Flyers, who are 37 for 184, about 1 in 5 on the power play, are 0 for 2 in the one game played here at the Forum against the Kings. Kings, meanwhile, have given up 60 power play goals, 180 short. They give about 1 every 3 when they're defending. Puck behind the Philadelphia attack net. Sittler digs it out, offensive right wing corner. Sittler out, along with Propp, and who has the puck along the near side, and Sinisalo, the point men, are Dvorak and Howe. There's a play in front. Sittler, a shot. Rebound. Rebound this time by Propp. He scores! Ryan Propp from Darryl Sittler, and it's 1-0 Philadelphia.
The power play had worked very well at this time, and what they did was they started getting more movement in it. Sittler and Propp were trying to really go to the net and try and draw that one defenseman away, and nobody knocked down Propp as he had two or three shots at it. As Kennedy let Sittler take the first shot, he took Sittler out, but then Propp was right there, and Wells just stick-checked him. Propp had a couple of shots at it before Wells got over there, and the Flyers have the early lead.
14:09, the time of the goal, as the Kings trail 1-0. Puck in alongside Lindbergh, and we're going to have an icing called. And we'd like to salute the first Wendy's Power Play winner this afternoon, Dennis Kelly of Pennsville, New Jersey. And again, you can enter the Wendy's Power Play Sweepstakes Contest by picking up a coupon in Wendy's and mailing it to the Flyers. Now, each time the Flyers score a power play goal, we'll present the winner of that power play goal dinner for four at Wendy's. And all of our goal-by-goal winners are eligible for the grand prize, which is a trip for two to one of the Stanley Cup Final road games, travel by courtesy of Rosenbluth Travel. So pick up your coupon at Wendy's today. So 1-0 Philadelphia as the Kings get it up into center ice. There goes Dion through into the zone, but unable to handle the puck. On his right was Danny Bonnar. Kings get it through to Dion. He fumbles it, taps it behind the Philadelphia net. Lindbergh sets it up, pokes it into the far corner. Off comes Dvorak, clears it through the stick of Dion into center ice. Dion quickly gets it again. He's tied up at center, but then Bonnar works into the zone, and off Lockhart does, and that's the thing Bobby says. He got in front of him. Didn't have to zing him. Didn't have to kill him. Just got in front of him, and there was nowhere for Bonnar to go to follow up the puck, and the Flyers come back at center ice. Lockhart is pulled down. Sweeps it into the zone along the right side, and there is Dion looking up ice. Tries to hit Bonnar. It hits the Flyers stick at his own line. That's McCrimmon above the shoulders. And when Holmgren coming off the bench takes it, he's called for the two line or for the high stick violation.
The official on that goal, Propp's 25th. Darryl Sittler, the only assist, 14:09 the time, and it's the power play goal for Philadelphia.
You wonder why the guy who got the puck into Sittler in the corner, Howe, didn't get an assist on that play. Then they threw it into the corner. Sitt came out front, took a whack. He was taken out, and then two whacks by Propp. But that, by the way, is the 38th power play goal for Philadelphia, number 7 of that variety for Propp. Flyers clear to the near side. Good check in there by Philadelphia on Darryl Evans, prevented him from really doing anything with the puck after he pinched in along the boards and stopped the outlet pass at Philadelphia. The guy doing that play, Brad McCrimmon. Then Wilson skating to his position.
Wilson's moved up to the wing here this afternoon, and Bob McCammon has really fluctuated him back between wing and defense.
All right, Philadelphia gets the draw near side. McCrimmon finds the opening, will come through at center ice unchallenged at the red line, flips offensive right corner, hits the glass, ricochets to the left of Mattson, who winds it around to his own defensive right side to Dean Hopkins. Outlet pass in front, taken by Ben Wilson, cleared a quick shot, but Dave Lewis did a nice job of cutting off the shot, controlling the puck, and getting it into center ice, where McCrimmon goes back through to Ben Wilson, lifts it high in the air, bounces in the corner to the left of Mattson, where Larry Murphy avoids the check of Paul Evans and gets it up on the near side and played through to center ice to Murphy by Doug Smith. There's a play in and a stop play and then an offside play by Los Angeles as Philadelphia really owning their own blue line. 4:10 remaining in the first period from the Forum in Los Angeles. It's the Flyers 1 and the Kings nothing.
You have 25 seconds to write down this toll-free number. Call it and find out about Delaware Cash Reserve. Find out for yourself how you can earn high money market dividends compounded daily with as little as $1,000 in an investment so liquid you can elect to write checks on it. Dial 1-800-523-4640. 523-4640. Delaware Cash Reserve, the money market fund from the Delaware Group.
Flyers coming up ice. Mark Howe loses control. Puck slides through to the Kings line where Jay Welch shoots it all the way back the other way over the Philadelphia goal line. icing call Los Angeles. You know, Proper only had 15 goals at the halfway point as Glenn Cochran skates up ice, but he's had 10 in his last 15 games of the second half, which puts him right back on mark with last year's 44-goal pace.
Well, you really like to see that happen. The Flyers weren't getting much scoring off their wing positions. Most of the scoring was coming from their centermen, and you get Billy Barber going and it really spreads it out. It's not as hard, or pardon me, it's not as easy to defend against.
1-0 Philadelphia with 3:53 remaining first period. Got an old friend, the Rabbit, will be our intermission guest, and Bob Froese. We'll have the Pepsi shootout on the television side. A lot of good things going on in intermission, so stay with us through the early evening hours as the Flyers work into the slot. Allison, no shot, dumps it offensive left wing corner for Lindsey Carson. Pushes off Jim Fox, centers it, but Korab is there to send it away to J.P. Kelly on the left wing at center right. Cross ice pass, bounced into the zone, overskating it though, as it bounced through him was Jim Fox. And then as he went in the zone, the puck came in after him offside.
Fox was a very high goal scorer in junior hockey, and he struggled for the first couple of years he was with the Kings, really couldn't find the mark, and he's starting to put the puck away a little bit more now, picking up 20 goals so far this season and 47 points, but he set in all kinds of goal scoring records in junior.
How did Ross Lonsberry get the name Rabbit?
I know they had a sign up in the Spectrum one time about that. We just saw it, so we just stuck.
Puck into the zone, up the middle. Sinisalo is pulled down by Mike Murphy and Ron Hogarth. You wonder whether there's a pattern. He was, we'll pick that up in a minute. As over the line, into the zone, goes Nichols, and the Dvorak takes it away, and he's tripped up, and the Kings swing back. Alf Isaacson over the line, and we have an offside on the left, Bernie Nichols. Ron Hogarth worked the Kings game Thursday night in Los Angeles, in which there were 48 penalties. Each team had 11 power play opportunities. And you wonder if that doesn't stick in the mind, and he's just doing the reverse today and not calling anything.
Well, it sure seems that way. He's only called the one penalty to Jay Wells, and he's let an awful lot go here in the opening 20 minutes.
Both ways. Marsh in his own zone, past Isaacson, all the way into the Kings zone. Retrieving it is Dean Kennedy, who's out with Mark Hardy on the Kings defense. Up front, they have Nichols, along with Isaacson, as they're going to have a breakaway, unless, oh, a good play by Billy Barber. As the defense got caught, there was Mike Murphy heading to the Flyer line, but Billy Barber got back to sweep the puck away from him. Kings out of their own zone. Murphy, nice move inside Billy Barber, up through to Bernie Nichols, and through into the zone, looking for Isaacson, takes the puck behind the Philadelphia net, avoids the Dvorak's check, loses the puck as Miroslav is double-teamed behind the net by Nichols. In there comes Brad Marsh, and we get a stoppage of play as we have a four-man tie-up. The players evenly divided.
Well, the Kings went for quite a few European players this year as well. Isaacson was out for much of the season. He's only picked up 21 points and seven of them goals, but the best one that they've had, or they, at least they said, was that Peter Helander, who's been out with a broken wrist from really early on in the season.
Well, they had that great triple crown line of Simmer, Taylor, and Dion, and then Simmer broke his leg, and Taylor broke his wrist, and then Dion is unhappy here. They might want to move him, and it's how quickly royalty fades. Puck at center ice. Very scrambly now. Flyers have had two good thrusts, one on a two-on-one Barber and Sittler. They didn't cash in on that. And then they had the power play goal scored by Prop. And the Kings have had much going except the play by Murphy, who came in from the right wing by himself. Since then, it's been rather scrambly hockey. The Flyers coming back. A lot of rolling puck, and you wonder whether the puck's been frozen up, the building is too warm, but boom, a good check behind the net by Clark, or by Holmgren, as the Flyers working down to the right wing corner. Holmgren goes after Mark Hardy, gives him again, ties him. I think we're going to have a penalty against Paul Holmgren.
Huh.
And it's going to be slashing?
This is what really is the most surprising thing about Ron Hogarth, is that he'll let, on both teams now, I'm not just saying because of this, but he'll let a lot of things go that are just obvious infractions, and then with ones that are just really borderline, he'll make the call on. Holmgren picks up a slashing minor. Right now, the Kings will have their first power play opportunity, and it'll come at 18-12 of this first period. Holmgren for slashing.
And he now has 136 minutes on the year. The Kings will be 12 seconds shy of having a full two-minute stretch in this period on the power play. There's only a minute 48 remaining. Kings 49 for 229 on the power play. A little less than 1-5, not up to their normal capacity. And against Philadelphia in the game they lost here 4-0, they were 0-6. Remarkable penalty record. They've only given up 12 power play goals in the last 136 times they've been short. That's over 93%. And on the road, they've only given up four in their last 53. Clark out along with Howe, and they have Marsh on the near side with Dvorak, and the Kings, as you might expect, will have Simmer out with Bonner and Dion. Murphy on the right side, and Evans, a big goal scorer with a big shot despite his diminutive size, is on the left point. Now the Kings through. Simmer again, not a good skater, takes the puck into the offensive corner. Dvorak winds it around far side. Howe's going to try to put pressure on Murphy, who clears it back behind for Simmer. Simmer looks, he's got an open man in front, and Bonner was taken off by Howe as the Kings try to go back in the corner, but the pass of Larry Murphy is deflected up over the end glass by Mark Howe with a minute 34 remaining on the penalty to Paul Holmgren. 1:22 in the first period, 1-0 Philadelphia. The penalties in the game are now even at one.
Los Angeles had seven opportunities on the power play in Edmonton on Thursday night, and they scored on four of them. So sometimes it just takes one game or a series of power play opportunities to get that power play working again.
Offensive right circle draw. Dion against Clark. No personnel changes out there. Clark, Marsh, Dvorak, and Howe against Dion, Bonner, Simmer, along with Larry Murphy and Darrell Evans at the point. Puck in the corner. Right side, gets inside Clark, back to the point. Murphy, left side to Darrell Evans. Back to Murphy, he's got Dion open near circle, goes back to the point and set to Darrell Evans, pulling over Mark Howe. In front, it's played by Bernie Nichols behind the net. The Kings have Dion at the side, it's poked loose into the corner by Clark. Clark looks for an outlet, spins to the forehand, then he falls down in the puck, and we're going to have a penalty for hooking against the Kings. And it looks like it's going to be Charlie Simmer.
No, it's Dion, G.
Dion going to be?
It's Marcel Dion hooked Clark as he tried to shoot the puck out from the deep corner to the left. And the power play opportunity will end just after 51 seconds of it in operation. And it'll be a hooking call on Marcel Dion. It'll come at 19:03. Clark was taking control of the puck, and just as he was ready to shoot it, that's when Dion hooked him. Puck park to the ice and away from the puck, and the Kings were able to control it in their own zone, or flyer zone rather, but the penalty was called.
All right, for Dion in the air, that gives him just 12 penalty minutes, the sixth minor. Bad time to have it, 57 seconds left. They'll play at five aside if there are no further penalties through the remainder of this period. Puck lifted to center ice. Marsh keeps it away from Ruskowski through to Mark Taylor in front to Evans. Knocked off and bumped off and fought off by Mark Hardy to the point where Bay's shot on the net is kicked away by Mattson. Far side, Hardy ties up Evans. The Flyers get it back to Bay again. Shot right on, and the deep rebound taken by Korab. Outlets on the left wing at center ice for Jim Cox. Coming through with Ruskowski to the near side. McCrimmon cuts off Ruskowski. The puck deep in along the Flyers' defensive right wing side. Ruskowski in there along with Taylor. In comes Jim Fox. The Flyers get some help as well from Paul Evans. We get a stoppage of play, and the Kings will get an offensive left circle faceoff with 19 seconds remaining in the period. During this intermission, first on the TV side, we're going to have a feature on youth hockey in the Delaware Valley with National Youth Hockey Week beginning today. While Mike Americk chats with Hockey Central director Andy Abramson, you'll see action in the Squirt Division with the Winter Sports Royals meeting the Valley Forge Colonials. While on radio, I'll be in conversation with the Flyers' Bob Froese. Then we'll be back, Bobby and I, for an analysis on this opening 20 minutes of play. 1-0 Philadelphia. Ruskowski, the draw against Philadelphia Sittler, won by Howe behind the net. Swings around to the left side. Now he's tied up by the checking of Ruskowski. Kicks the puck free. Takes Ruskowski out. Still has the puck and works up on the far side. Past Barber and all the way down. And that'll do it as the clock ticks down 4 seconds. Three, the puck retrieved behind the Kings net. 2-1, and we'll have the siren and horn blow to end the first period from Inglewood, California, the fabulous Forum. The score, the Philadelphia Flyers 1, the Los Angeles Kings nothing, as our intermission activities will continue after this.
Coca-Cola says it's the real thing, but Pepsi believes that when it comes to colas, the only real thing is taste. That's why the Pepsi Challenge has been asking thousands of people across the country to let their own taste decide. And the fact is, nationwide, more people...
But yet, there are still other men whose talents are on outwitting. Snipers and stoppers, both capable at any second fraction of magic.
I never believed in things that I couldn't see. I said, if I can't feel it, then how could it be? No magic could happen to me. And then I saw you, I couldn't believe it. You took my heart, I couldn't retrieve it. Said to myself, what's it all about? Now I know there can be a
spell, you will get your...
Hi, we're back at the Forum, Gene Hart with Bobby Taylor. They'll each start the second period, the Kings and Flyers respectively, with a man at the box. Paul Holmgren will come out in 12 seconds. Then the Flyers will have a 51-second power play, their second of the game. They're one for one. That represents, Bobby, the only goal of the game. Prop is 25th from Sittler at 14:09.
Well, I think that's one thing that can win you games. If you can't get anything else going and then you get that power play working, that'll steal you an awful lot of points as well as your penalty killing preventable.
Marcus Mattsson was doing a deep knee bend in the net, and the way they cheered, I thought they had made a goaler change, but we saw his number. We'll pause for station identification on the Flyers Hockey Network.
This is WTAF, TV 29 in Philadelphia.
Play is on, early second period. Flyers waiting for a man back as they send Sittler down the right side, trail by Prop. Over the line, the penalty is over. Shot in on Mattsson. Prop takes it behind the net. Philadelphia on the advantage, but the Kings roll up to Korab in front, and he just wrists it all the way down. Philadelphia 1-for-1 on the game and 1-for-3 on the season against the Kings. Their second opportunity. They lose it along the near side. Roskowski out with Darrell Evans and Korab back with Mark Hardy as Roskowski penetrates down the right side. He's boxed by three Flyers. Holds the puck and a masterful bit of penalty killing. Finally, with 23 seconds on the advantage, loses it. And Prop gets it up on the right wing at center to Sittler. Over the line. Drops at the point. Closing in Sinisalo. Back to the point to Howe. To Sinisalo into the right wing circle. Back to Howe at the point. Back to Sinisalo at the circle. Corner into Sittler, and they're wasting all the time. 8 seconds left. Sittler there to Sinisalo behind the net. Sinisalo holds. Goes back behind to Sittler. They're working but not getting a shot. Sittler back to the point. The penalty is over. Howe with a rolling puck shoots right into the breadbasket of Mattsson as the penalty is over, and the Flyers work for one shot, which was not a high percentage drive.
Well, it was not a... It didn't come on the power play either, but the shot, or puck rather, was rolling, and Howe got it away and got it up, and anytime you can get it up over the knees or between the knees and the shoulders, it's easy picking for goaltenders, especially if they can see it all the way.
Penalty box is now empty. Carson, Clark, and Allison out with McCrimmon and Bave, and the Kings counter with Doug Smith at center ice with Hopkins and Darrell Evans, defensively Dave Lewis with Larry Murphy. The referee is Ron Hogarth, the linesman Ryan Bozak, and Dan Maruelli. Doug Smith against Flyers Bobby Clark. Ryan Bozak will handle the drop. Clark gets it back to the point. Left side pass off the boards to Bave. Drive in on the net. Pad save. Beautiful one. And a first really outstanding save of the game by Mattsson. Now coming in front. From the right corner by Brad McCrimmon. That's his best goal as a Philadelphia Flyer.
Boy, did he ever take a nice shot as the Kings were trying to keep the players from in front of the net and screening Mattsson. But McCrimmon just picked up that rebound off of a shot from Frank Bave and just moved in and found that short side. But Bave waited and waited to try and set up a screen. The Kings were caught as McCrimmon just went right around Evans. Evans trying to do the stick checking, and then all he did was came in, beat Mattson to the short side, high over the shoulder, and the Flyers have that 2-0 lead. Brad McCrimmon's first. Faith will get, or second, rather. He'll probably get the assist. Will go to one, at least, to Frank Bays, and it comes at 1:18.
Brad's other goal was December 12th at the Spectrum in Philadelphia's 4-3 victory against the Pittsburgh Penguins. Flyers shoot it up ice into the King zone, retrieving it deep in his own right wing corner. Is Larry Murphy goes back behind the net away from Clark, forechecking to Dave Lewis. Clark misses a check on Lewis, goes down heavily as the Kings try to come out along their right wing side, are boxed in. Now they work a second opportunity, stolen away by Philadelphia's Lindsey Carson. In front to the point to Ray Allison, drive right in, and it's grabbed by Mattson in the right catching glove for the stoppage of play.
They've given that assist to Allison, Gene, and I don't, unless Ray passed it back to Bathe, but Bathe has not been given the official assist on that goal. McCrimmon scores it at 1:18. And Allison just went by and let McCrimmon take the puck. Off the boards, come in and beat Mattson to the high on the short side. And it was off a rebound of the shot from Frank Bays that McCrimmon was able to pick up the shot. But they've given the assist to Allison and not to Bays.
All right, 1:18 is still on the board. 2-0 Philadelphia, early second period. There's a play in front. Flyers unable to get a peek at it. And it's cleared along the near side by Jay Wells to center ice. Wells back with Korab on the King defense. And up front, they go along with Evans as Philadelphia and Simmer along with Dion. And the Flyers, as the Kings take it at center, Wells tries to flip in and hits the rump of Flockhart, who's on with Holmgren and prop. Ricochets back to the Kings line. Jay Wells from Korab up the middle of the ice. Flyers stretched across the line, so Wells flips into the right of Lindbergh, sets it up for Dvorak, a wraparound to the near side. Bonner picks it off. Had a man all alone in front, Dion, if he'd have been able to control that wraparound, but was unable to. And then the Flyers, Dvorak on the near side, rolls it up the prop. Hart lets the Flockhart 1-2 at center ice against Wells. Swings way to the right. Tries to cut inside Wells, who sweeps it off Flockhart's stick for the Kings behind his own net. Plays to Korab out of the Kings' offensive right corner, where Korab then shoots it to center ice. Dvorak has it there, bangs it to Sinisalo, drops it back far side. Oh, a careless pass. Dion almost read it and picked it off. But Marsh was there. Dvorak was able to get it to center ice. Then the Kings flip offensive right corner. Marsh in there along with Jay Wells. Isaacson behind the net is cut off by Dvorak, who gets it up to Sinisalo and through to Sittler at center ice. At the Kings line, 70-footer. Mattson grabs with the right glove, looks to play past Sittler and does into the near corner. The Flyers forechecking, but back comes Mike Murphy at center ice along with Isaacson and Nichols over the line. Murphy inside Howe, but nice job by Sinisalo just to poke it off Murphy's stick. And the puck caroms around behind the Flyer net where it's wound up by Howe to Sinisalo. Loses it, pulls down Murphy, and that's going to be a careless play penalty by Ilkka Sinisalo, pulling down Mike Murphy at 3:24 of the second period. Penalties are even at 2. Kings power play coming up. Flyers 2 and Kings nothing.
Activision challenges you to the video games of your life. Designed for your Atari video computer system, demanding all your speed, strategy, and skills. So amazingly real, you'll believe Activision puts you in the game.
Video Den, Havertown, Pennsylvania. Video Vision, Philadelphia, PA.
3:24 is the time of that tripping minor to Ilkka Sinisalo, LA's second power play.
They're 0-1 on the night, 0-7 on the year against Philadelphia. Sinisalo with 8 penalty minutes. The Kings get it back at the point. Evans toward the net. And Lindbergh, pad saves it off to his right. But the rebound is taken off by J.P. Kelly. Works past Clark to the point. Quick pressure on Larry Murphy, and he can only roll it down the right boards behind the net. In there is Jim Fox to the corner to Ruskowski. Bump by Bathe and Howe, but they still get it back to Murphy at the point. Shot deflected way wide to the left of Lindbergh, around to the far corner, and the Kings really going after the puck, but the Flyers get it to Clark. Oh, through to Howe at center ice, one-on-one, along with Larry Murphy. Gets past Murphy, into the left corner, quick shot in on the net, as Murphy then got a shoulder in and rolled Howe out, and Mark's quick shot didn't have a whole lot of mustard on it, but nonetheless, Mattson grabbed and hung on for stoppage.
Excellent play by Larry Murphy to keep that Mark Howe to the outside. And again, it's very important when you're playing that one-on-one situation that that defenseman just plays the body, and he did it perfectly that time. And Howe just got a weak shot that Mattson made the easy save on. But you know, a lot of times the players will start looking at that puck, and that's when the puck carrier will really undress the defenseman.
Coming out of the Kings dressing room is Doug Smith, who or Isaacson, who apparently needed some late repairs. We've got Taylor out with Prop killing the penalty with Dvorak and Marsh. And Roskowski is on with Kelly and Fox. And defensively, or offensively on the power play, they've got Murphy at one point, Darrell Evans at the other. Here comes Jim Fox at center ice. Works past the hook check of Mark Taylor to the far side. Wraps around behind Lindbergh. Sets it up for Marsh. Marsh is slapped to the near side, partially blocked. So Mark Taylor is tied up by Larry Murphy. Dvorak comes in along the near side with J.P. Kelly. A lot of action along the Flyers' defensive left wing corner. Three Kings, three Flyers. The puck kicks out. Boom! Down goes Mark Taylor as the Kings try to work out of that corner. And finally, Rowan Hogarth, as it looks like a partial demolition derby to the left of goaltender Lindbergh. We get a stoppage with 58 seconds remaining on the Ilka Sinisalo penalty. 4:26 gone, second period, 2-0 Philadelphia.
Now Taylor out there with Prop have become a very effective power for penalty-killing unit. Of course, Clark and Howe have done exceptional for the Flyers. In fact, it was when Howe, and we've kept pointing that out, moved up to that forward position in the man short situation. That's when the Flyers penalty-killing team really took off, and they lead the league.
Flyers out shooting the Kings 18-8 for the game and 5-1 in this period. Penalties even at 2. Kings again 0-1 in the advantage, 0-7 on the year against Philadelphia. Nichols with Simmer left, Dion right, Murphy and Evans, as Don Torrey wants to get something on the board. Mark and Howe along with McCrimmon and Bay. Defensive left circle, Philadelphia. Back to Murphy. Sets up the forehand drive. Nice pad save in front by Lindbergh. Rebound kicked out by Howe to Clark, and he drifts it into center ice. Murphy retrieves it his own line. Spins off away from the forechecking of Clark and Howe. But the puck given away in the zone. Howe steals it off. Offensive right corner. Slips, falls, and the Kings break out 4-on-2. Right wing pass to Dion. Over the line against Bave. Up the middle. Shot. High over the right shoulder of Lindbergh, who didn't move till the puck cleared past the goal. Puck down behind the Philadelphia net. McCrimmon takes out his man, winds back to the right point. Murphy goes to the forehand in front, directed in by Simmer, and cleared away by goaltender Lindbergh. As Simmer just tried to redirect, then Lindbergh made the cover-up as the Kings get their best opportunity of the game. Flyers follow up by shooting it down the ice with 15 seconds on the advantage. Evans off the Korab as the Flyers have Sittler and Barber out with Dvorak and Marsh. Through over the line, Dion holds at the right point. Left side to Evans, he lets one go. Blocked off by Philadelphia's Barber, who breaks out at center ice. The penalty is over. At the Kings line, drive on Matson. Kick save in front. Steered away from Sittler by Darrell Evans and round up to the near side where Sinisalo puts it in front to Barber. To Marsh, drive from the point, off the stick. Up Dion deflects off the top of the glass behind the Kings net. Cleared back behind, and there is Barber forechecking, but Korab gets it near side. Dion can't get out thanks to Marsh going in deep and pinching off the offensive left board. So Korab goes up on the far side, and the Kings get it to center. Dvorak has it there, rolls it up the middle. Sinisalo back from Sittler, through to Barber, in front. Sinisalo directed in on the net, and Motson got that left pad out on a dandy three-way passing play that just failed to click. Kings lifted in the air back to the Flyer line, and the Flyers try to drive out and do. Passed everyone down the near boards into their zone. Jay Wells shoots it into the Flyer player bench along the near side for the stoppage. 6:08 gone into the second period from the Forum in Inglewood, California. The Flyers 2 and the Kings nothing.
The airline that doesn't plan for the future may not have one. 5 years ago, Eastern saw the future in a remarkable aircraft. Now it's here. The new Boeing 757, the most advanced, most fuel-efficient commercial jet ever built. It's going to help Eastern hold down the cost of flying for years to come.
We earn our wings for you, that's why we're Eastern, America's favorite way.
We're back at the Forum, 2-0 Philadelphia. We've had two afternoon finals. The Bruins continued on their merry way with Marc O'Barron in the net, beating Hartford 7-4 at Boston Garden. And in Quebec, it was Quebec and Buffalo playing a scoreless game tie. Second one of the season, of course, Philadelphia-Pittsburgh was the other. Now with play on here, Lockhart threw at the Kings line. Long shot, blocked into the far corner by Dean Kennedy of the Kings. Holmgren in there along with Mark Hardy. Then in comes Doug Smith for the up there's Holmgren at the side of the net. We're going to say Doug Smith with Clockhart as the Flyers are going to pick up another penalty against Holmgren for pulling down Doug Smith behind the Los Angeles net. Up on the far side, the Kings now trying to keep the play going so they can get the goaltender and the extra forward. But now the penalty is called, so Holmgren goes off for the second time in the game. The Flyers' third penalty of 5 whistled by Ron Hogarth. Kings power play coming up, 13:08 remaining, second period, 2-0 Philadelphia.
You want some? something better. Yeah, you won't take second best. You want it delicious. For you, there's nothing less than Wendy's all-white chicken sandwich. Better you can't find. With a real delicious chicken breast. That's not the process kind. That's why you're
LA gets their third power play as Holmgren's off for tripping at 6:52.
0 for 2 in the afternoon, 0 for 8 against Philadelphia. It's odd that a club that dominates LA as much as Philadelphia, Flyers have four power plays in the two games and the Kings eight. Is that what they call handicapping? Kings in their zone. They'll have Korab, who scored a few power play goals in his day against Philadelphia for Buffalo. And here they come at center ice. Murphy through to Nichols over the line, trying to go right on through. He's at the side of the net, just failed to reach it as Lindbergh dove out. And then as Howe tried to clear out of his own left wing corner, it ricocheted out of the rink off Dion, and we'll have a neutral zone face-off.
Well, Gene, I'll tell you, it's really a treat for Brad McCrimmon to score that goal for Philadelphia, because he has his grandpa and grandma here from Phoenix, and they've never ever seen him play before. So their first game that he's here, that they get to see him play, he scores a goal for them.
Zimmer and Dion on the opposite wings with Nichols at center, Korab and Larry Murphy, the point men. The Flyers, Clark and Howe, with Bathe and McCrimmon face off just outside the Philadelphia line along their left wing. Flyers win the draw, and it's sent all the way down off Larry Murphy's stick. It ricochets in on Mattson, plays off the left wing for Zimmer. Drives it back behind the net away from the checking of Clark, and now Howe goes after Murphy. He has to go back to that same far corner for Zimmer. We have a minute and 25 seconds on the King power play as the Flyers pestering. And now Dion in full pursuit at center ice along the left wing. Crisscrosses with Nichols over the line. Spins to the near side. Still controls the puck to the point to Murphy. Murphy into the slot. Goes left side to Korab. Look. Drive on the net. Oh, and hit the outside of the post to the long side. Lindbergh, perhaps off the goaler. Now Korab again. Another shot. Kicked back into that far corner to Nichols by Lindbergh. Flyers take it off. McCrimmon to Clark. And he rolls it through the defense of Los Angeles at the Philadelphia line and down the ice. Now out there comes Taylor and Propp as Dion threw at the Flyer line. Penetrates but puts it right on Propp's stick. Pivots and rolls the through into center ice off Bernie Nichols' blade of Los Angeles. Korab and Murphy still back, and up front they have Nichols still. Now with there's enough of that, he'll be replaced by Jim Fox on the right. And just as he goes to the bench, the puck is flipped out of the rink over the penalty. Far side with 11:46 remaining second period, 38 seconds on the Holmgren penalty, and it is still 2-0 Philadelphia. Bobby for Holmgren is second of the day, and he has 138 minutes on the year. Fox, along with Ruskowski and Kelly, and they go with Mark Hardy at the left point, and on the near side, the extra forward is Darrell Evans. Dvorak with Marsh and Taylor with Propp. Puck in the King zone. 30 seconds on the advantage. Working up on the near side. Ruskowski on a give and go with Fox. Can't find it. Dumps it into the zone. Marsh blocks it down, but it goes into the corner off his body to Ruskowski. Ruskowski is checked by Dvorak. Back to the point. Evans had it skip right through him as he looked as if he wanted to set up and drive the slap shot in on net. Now Marsh over the line shoots as the Kings let him penetrate. Quickly, Ray Allison picks up his position. As the Kings try to come back, Kelly lifts it into the Flyer zone, deep into the corner left of Lindbergh. Marsh is there along with two Kings. They want to get it back to the point to Korab. The penalty is over. Slot pass in. Mark Hardy a shot. Save and a beauty by Lindbergh, who saw that shot coming all the way and cut off the angle. As the Flyers come through on the near wing, Holmgren out of the penalty box. As the Flyers, oh, they got Allison in front. He's there. Shot. Oh, and the Marcus Mattson got that maybe with the wrist of his catching glove right side to keep it away. Back come the Kings at center. Fox at the Flyer line. Swings to the far near side. Then has the puck checked off a stick by Carson and sent by Philadelphia's Cochran to center ice. Flyers have Dvorak out with Cochran. And up front they have Allison along with Carson and Evans playing the center ice, giving Clark a breather after killing that penalty served by Holmgren. As the puck is tied up just a stride inside the Kings offensive right wing side, we get a stoppage of play.
Well, I'll tell you, Los Angeles had an excellent shot as Wills came right in, and Billy Member just moved right out to challenge him, stayed down on the play and made the big save and kicked the rebound into the corner. And Lindbergh looks awfully sharp in there, Gene. He hasn't had much action, but he looks very sharp even after that long layoff.
21-11, the shots Philadelphia in this period, 8-4. You know, you always notice sometimes when you get a second shot at a play, how often on a play like that, the guy behind Lindbergh is Brad Marsh covering the net, so if the puck maybe gets through the five hole, or dribbles to the side, Marsh is there to keep it away. Flyers fail to clear, it's kept in at the point, drive wide of Lindbergh and comes to his right, and he gets the glove.
Has not won their in their last three home games. They lost twice, I think Calgary and the Islanders. Tied the New York Rangers here last Tuesday, I believe.
But they've been scoring goals. They lost to Calgary 8-6. They tied the Rangers 5-5 and lost to the Islanders 4-6. And the Islanders' sixth goal was an empty netter. So that's tough, you know, when you score 15 goals in three home games and you don't win a one. Doug Smith out with Dean Hopkins, Darrell Evans. There is a along the near side. 10 minutes remaining in this second period. Now 10:03 as the Flyers shoot it out of the rink and the Kings can get an offensive right. Well, we got Bade and Dean Hopkins eyeballing.
Hopkins going to come with that as Hopkins laid a solid check on there. They're just probably exchanging pleasantries.
You know, we mentioned earlier, Bobby, that Kenny Lintzman got involved with Doug Kennedy, or Dean Kennedy, in a brouhaha Thursday at Edmonton.
Well, it was one of the three now that the players have engaged in fights off the ice as they were going to their respective dressing rooms. Lintzman was supposed to have stuck Kennedy in the face with a stick to cut him, supposedly.
Puck wound by the Flyers on the draw. Dean Hopkins cuts it off, puts it in at the side of the net. Trying to get a piece of it, unable to do so with Darrell Evans. Flyers go around to the far side. McCrimmon, who has the Flyer goal in his period smartly, to Sittler at center ice, through to Barber, tries to razzle-dazzle through, and it's taken away by Larry Murphy up on the left wing to Doug Smith. Fights past the stick and hook check of Sinisalo. The Flyers take it off. Close up at center ice. McCrimmon over the red line. Right wings into the zone to Sittler. Bounced off the skate. Follows it up in the corner. Loses his balance. Can't follow up the play as the Kings work it to their own defensive left wing side and send it to Doug Smith. Crisscrossing with Hopkins on his left at the Flyer line. At the line. Wants the shot. Swings wide to the near side. Puts it in on the net. Blocked by the skate of Hopkins, who takes it in the offensive corner. He's tied up. This is Darrell Evans. They can't get anything out of that corner generated offensively. Now a good play behind the net by Hopkins. Kicking it free from Frank Bathe as he didn't have a stick down, and finally he overskates the puck, and McCrimmon gets it off the near side to Barber, slaps it up to Mark Taylor, and through to Barber at center ice, a rolling puck to Taylor, into the zone, Barber will follow up into the corner, he's got two men in front, Sittler there, shot, makes that McCrimmon, who had a chance at his second goal, and he goes off. The only reason I said Sittler, that's where he belonged. Now the Kings back, Sittler's going to wind up, takes the shot, left corner, into the corner, puts it off the side of the net, and Lindbergh dropped it off his glove, but then made sure the pads covered any possible whack from a Kings trailing player, and hung on for the stoppage of play with 8:42 remaining second period from the Forum in Inglewood, California. Flyers 2 and the Kings nothing. Along with Bobby Taylor at the Forum in Inglewood, California, 8:42 remaining second period, 2-0 Philadelphia. The goal scorer's prop in the first on the power play, McCrimmon in the second. And we have the penalties 3-2 Philadelphia, the shots 22-13. Kings give it away behind the net. Paul Evans gives it to Ben Wilson. Looks to center. It does. Taken off and shot on the net. As it appeared, Dean Kennedy had it, but rolled off a stick to Ben Wilson, who got the drive. Back to the point. Marsh's shot. Bounces wide of the net as Evans is taken off smartly by Mark Hardy behind. Then quickly in there for Philadelphia is Mark Taylor to tie up Dean Kennedy. And we get a standoff with four players evenly divided between the two clubs.
Hey, the Flyers are back home Thursday evening against the St. Louis Blues. That's this coming Thursday. And you get tickets for this game and all the other Flyers games at the Spectrum box office or the Ticketron outlets in the Delaware Valley.
Kings make a defensive change with a faceoff in their own zone. They get Dion out, bring out Nichols, along with Mike Murphy and Ulf Isaacson. The Flyers have the Flockhart line with Holmgren and Propp, defensively Cochran with Howe. Offensive left circle. Puck is dropped, pops up in the air. Dean Kennedy takes it, wraps it back to the near side to Mike Murphy. Murphy up through at center ice, rolls it onto the stick of Murphy into the Philadelphia zone. In pursuit is Isaacson, cut off as Lindbergh steers it around to the near side. Murphy goes back the other way as Lindbergh was held off the net from behind. Kings get it into the near side. Kennedy rolls it in front of the net. Little scrambly play. Finally cleared by the Flyers off Lockhart's stick to center ice. Avoids two checks. Spins past Nichols. Throw at the Kings line. Gets past the third. Puts it in the slot. But by then the Kings had everybody back. Picked off the puck and shot at the center ice. Cochran retreating away from Mike Murphy, shoots it to center. And Mark Hardy for the Kings, who's back with Dean Kennedy, grabs it into the Los Angeles zone along the near wing. Weak pass by Kennedy to his own left wing circle for Hardy. Gets it up into center ice to the Flyer line where Cochran has it. Goes back the other way, and it's tipped by Howe into the Kings zone. Cat and mouse now with 7:20 remaining in the second period as Murphy tries to go through to Nichols. Flyers break up that play, and very scrambly now. Shinny at center ice as Kennedy comes at Holmgren high, so Holmgren goes high as well to block off as the Kings work the puck out of their own zone to give it away to Ray Allison at center ice. Allison on with Clark and Carson, and the line is Bays along with McCrimmon. McCrimmon has one of the goals. Now back is Nichols. He's going to shoot. Hits Bays, blocked in front and cleared by Clark into the near corner. Whacked away from the Kings, Mike Murphy to the near side by Frank Bays. Clark in the corner, takes a stiff check from J.P. Kelly. Centering pass to Korat, can't handle it, and Philadelphia's Allison breaks pass, has trouble handling it, lost the two-on-one, then opens a pass to the right wing at the King line to Clark. Flips it into the zone, and we have an offside. As Kelly is going after the Clark, and McCrimmon is over there, and everybody joins in. Some quickly and some slowly, except the goaltender is right at the Flyer right wing at the Kings blue line, and it looks like it's settling down. Clark, who was the original target, now is broken off and is talking with J.P. Kelly and Frank Bays. We have from the Forum in Inglewood, California, 6:32 remaining in the Flyer 2 and Los Angeles nothing.
Born of tradition, nurtured by pride. Budweiser Light, with a clean, distinctive taste. A light beer worthy of the king of beers.
Bring out your best. Bring out your best.
The best never comes easy.
Budweiser Light.
That's why there's nothing else like it.
Back at the Forum, Sittler, Sinisalo, and Barber out along with Dvorak and Marsh, and the Kings with Simmer, Dion, and Dan Bonner. They flip into the Flyer zone, into the near corner. Dion grabs a hold of Marsh. Dvorak is tied up by Bonner. Simmer is in there trying to break it free. Comes to the point, blocked off into the corner. There's Bonner in the slot. Short side shot wide of Lindbergh and cleared to the far side by Sinisalo and up to Sittler, who just deflects into the neutral zone. It's tied up by Simmer on the far side with Philadelphia Sinisalo right at the blue line, right wing Philadelphia side. We get a stoppage.
Flyers have done an excellent job of checking off the Kings. They're not allowing them to get into that slot area or get any kind of shots on goal, and they're playing a very solid defensive style of hockey here in the second period. That could be very, very frustrating when you have a free-reeling team such as Los Angeles.
All right, again, Sinisalo, Sittler, and Barber with Dvorak and Marsh. It's Korat back now with Jay Wells for the Kings. Up front still it is Bonar with Simmer. Oh, there's a break. Simmer down in the left wing corner on deflection as he was left by Sinisalo. Tries the centering pass. Boom, into the net goes Jay Wells as he was checked by Marsh. But behind the Philadelphia goal, King's trying to come out with it, but it kicks to Billy Barber. And Barber's pass blocked back by the body of Korat behind the Philadelphia net, but it's given to Dvorak by Marsh. And Dvorak shoots it all the way down right past Jerry Korat over the King's goal line. King Kong recovers for the icing with 5:33 remaining second period. 2-0 Philadelphia penalties. 3-2 Philadelphia. The shot 23-13 Flyers.
Marsh and Dvorak wanted to get a line change, and they were expecting that getting out cleanly up at the boards there. But when the puck was bounced back in their zone, it took a crazy hop, and then they just wanted to make sure they got it out so that they could get off. That's one thing you got to be very conscious of, is that overstaying your shift. And you don't want to be out there too long, because that's when most opportunities or goals are scored, and you have that guy out there too long.
All right. They're doing some repair work at the top edge of Pelle Lindbergh's crease. Ryan Bozak doing the honors. And again, the new linesman, you fool with a name, Dan Morouelli. M-A-R-O-U-E-L-L-I. Was a name, the closest I could ever think of sports was a... Remember the Italian boxer in the early 40s, Tammy Moriello?
In the early 40s?
Yeah.
I wasn't born then.
Well, don't you read books? I mean, you weren't born, but you've heard of Lincoln, haven't you? 14. These Canadians. Ta-ta-ta-ta! Trivia question coming up soon. I'll give it to you right now. The last time the Flyers lost was the 20th of October, 1973, at the Forum in Los Angeles. They lost 3-0. Who was the shutout goaltender for the Kings in that game? The last time the Flyers lost here was the 20th of October, 1973, 3-0. Who was the Kings goaler? Puck behind the Philadelphia net, as the Flyers have out Mark Howe. Goes left side to Cochran. Cochran threw into the neutral zone, and it's blocked by Prop to the far side, and he has to go back into the zone for Howe for control. Howe challenged, gets it up, bounces it through to Philadelphia's Prop, or Flockhart. He's blocked off, and the Kings trying to come back. Nice sweep check by Philadelphia's Howe. Gets it up to Prop, and down that right wing to Flockhart. Up the middle. There, drive. Oh, over the right shoulder of Mattson, to the right point to Cochran. Into the near side. Prop has it to the goal line left, and then Holmgren puts it in front, and the Kings take it off. Is right there where he belonged was Darrell Evans. Kings shoot it up, almost a two-on-one, but who was back there? Mr. Smooth, Mark Howe, just to pick it off. And you know, every time something looks threatening, Bob, there's number two just doing a nice little move on picking it off. Now the Kings throw it back in the Flyers zone, and Cochran lifts it, but not out. Kings, and there's Mr. Howe again, taking up the loose puck, as the Flyers having a little trouble maneuvering and getting any offense going. 4:30 remaining in the second period, 2-0. As the Flyers change, the Kings get it up to Doug Smith. Tries to get past McCrimmon, who just takes him right out smoothly. Then Wilson trails in after the loose puck as he's on the floor. ...of the ice at the Kings line. Shot. Mattson steers off to his left. Rebound is poked into the corner. Loose. Philadelphia in front. Short side shot by Evans, and Mattson covered the short side well, as the Flyers almost got an opportunity play out of the corner. Kings on the far side. Puck stolen by Mark Taylor. Offensive right corner. Tries to put it in front. Blocked off. Then Wilson goes back to the point to McCrimmon. McCrimmon along the circle. Evans lets it go in the corner. Played by Ben Wilson. Right in goal from Taylor. And Taylor's just upset because about a half a stride away from Evans on that given goal. 3:52 remaining in the second period with the stoppage of play. Flyers 2 and the Kings nothing.
1902, when the Wright brothers were still making bicycles, Rosenbluth already had 10 years of experience in travel. Today, with more than 90 years of travel experience, more people count on Rosenbluth than anyone else in the Delaware Valley. They count on Rosenbluth to help them fly Olympic Airways with new low fares to Greece, daily nonstop 747s, and spectacular Greek island fly cruise or private yacht packages. And while anyone can put you on an Olympic flight, only Rosenbluth lets you travel with more than 90 years of experience.
We'll give you the answer, or Chief will try to. The last goaltender to beat Philadelphia in this building for the Kings, October the 20th, 1973, did it 3-0. Puck in the Flyers' offensive right circle, cleared to the near side. Where and Simmer break it up, comes to center ice. There's a play in by Korab. It'll be an icing. Easy giving. All right. Give a guess. I'll tell you, I'll give you an easy clue. The goaltender who did it is in the building today.
Well, I was just going to say that. Rogatin Vachon. Right?
Yeah. Rogi Vachon. The gentleman to my right wrote Jerry Desjardins. Jerry didn't shut out too many people, particularly the Philadelphia Flyers. Did you get it at home? And you might announce why Mr. Vachon is here.
Well, he has now just been named this week, as a matter of fact, the new goaltending coach for the Los Angeles Kings.
What if he still has the big handlebar mustache?
I saw him here, Gene. He does.
All right, the Kings win the draw after a short shot in on Mattson, and it's sent by Bonner to center ice, out with Dion and Simmer. McCrimmon gets it past Dion to center ice. The Kings try to make a move, but Korab is stopped, and it's shot by Los Angeles back down behind Philadelphia's Lindbergh. Cleared by the Flyers, but not out. Wrapped behind the net. There is Simmer. He's got a man off to the side. Shot by Bonner, and Lindbergh just hugged the post, and there was nowhere for the puck to go except off Lindbergh into the far corner, where it's cleared by McCrimmon all the way down. McCrimmon and Babe go off. Dvorak and Marchand. Carson out there now with Ben Wilson and Mark Taylor, as the Flyers unable to get a line change completed. Now it comes to center, and Carson will wrap it in on Mattson off his body as the Flyers now complete that line change. Carson, Clark, and Allison out, along with Dvorak and Marsh. And it is Wells with Korab for Los Angeles. Now with Simmer on with Ruskowski and Fox. Simmer wants to go off to be replaced by J.P. Kelly and does. Flyers working deep in their corner, out of their own right wing circle. It's played by Dvorak to Ray Allison. Comes over the red line, flips offensive left wing corner. In there is Lindsey Carson, and the Kings sweep it away to Jim Fox. Turns with 2 minutes remaining in the second period, 2:30. Comes to the Philadelphia line, and it's broken up by the Flyers. Boy, I tell you, the Flyers just do not allow the Kings to come in. They get it up at center ice, through where Allison drives it down the left wing boards behind Mattson. Carson is cut off by J.P. Kelly, then Ruskowski on the far side bumps into Dvorak. Puck at the blue line to Clark, lifts it in at the side of the Kings net where it's played by Jay Wells to his own left wing corner for J.P. Kelly. He's tied up by Clark, and Ron Hogarth from the other side of the ice calls a stoppage of play. 2:02 remaining second period, 2-0 Philadelphia.
Well, it's just a masterful job, and you watched Bobby Clark out there with along with Carson and Allison, and they play their position so well, and that's a key. When you have the two men deep, the other guy will pick up that third man in the slot or stay in that high slot, and the Flyers have been doing that excellently this whole road trip. Is they've just announced the attendance, 14,146 people here.
Zittler, Sinisalo, and Barber along with Cochran and Howe on the Kings counter, with Doug Smith at center, with Dean Hopkins on his right, Darrell Evans on the left, along with Larry Murphy and, as we said, Jay Wells. Offensive right circle, Sittler against Doug Smith. Darrell Evans, that sounds like a baseball player, but what's that, Dwight Evans?
Yeah.
Okay. Puck at the side of the net, swept away from Barber. The Kings quickly get it to Dean Hopkins on the right side, looking for Evans. Gets a half a step, but then Howe cuts him off. Pokes the puck loose to Sinisalo. He overskates. The Kings in the slot. Shot saved by Lindbergh on the deflection. In front again. And it kicks around in front. They shoot out. Oh, and it goes wide of the corner. Oh,
what a
my.
Save by Pelle Lindbergh, though, Gene. Holy cow.
Just outstanding. And the Flyers are going to be whistled for an icing unless Sittler can get to the puck first. There's the stoppage in play. Boy, I'll tell you, that's a 12-beller.
Well, you know, and it was a very simple play because Howe had gotten back and deflected the puck away, and Sinisalo didn't control it along the boards. Coughed it up, and that's when the Kings really put an awful lot of pressure on. But a good shot from Smith. It was a deflection that Lindbergh finally made the save with his chest protector, and they still had it around, and the big save came just a bit later on as they took a real quick shot. It came through a maze of players, and Lindbergh was able to go to his knees and kick out that left skate to make the save, and then the rebound rolled wide. But two big saves by Pelle Lindbergh.
The Kings got their first real good burst, consistent burst on the net, as they are now shooting, or even with the Flyers in shots. Bad giveaway in the zone. Dion, that's the last guy you want to give it to at the blue line. Into the slot. Flyers break it up. And they don't get it out. The play is hanging a little bit. Then it's a bad King pass into the slot by Simmer. Philadelphia picks it off, gets it to center. Flockhart out with Propp and Holmgren along with McCrimmon and Bave. And it is Murphy now on with Dion over the line. Right circle. Wide of the right side of Lindbergh, who got the pad down. As down goes Holmgren with the Kings having it behind the net. Flockhart digs it out as McCrimmon tied up Simmer well. Flockhart working up the middle of the ice. Flips it in on the right side past Holmgren. Ricochets to the left of Mattson. Leaves it there, but boom, a nice forecheck job by Holmgren. Keeps the puck up for grabs until it's played by Mike Murphy. Off to Larry Murphy, who comes to center. Boy, the Kings are skating now. Murphy into the zone. Offside on his left, though, is Charlie Simmer with 42 seconds remaining in the second period. It is 2-0 Philadelphia, and again, the shots are even in this period, 11, 24-18 for Philadelphia in the game. Now, coming up during this intermission, on the TV side, you're going to see the Pepsi shootout. While on radio, I'll be talking with the happy rabbit, Ross Lonsbury. Then the Chief and I will be back to analyze this big second 20 minutes of play as the Flyers have matched their first period performance, scoring a goal. Penalties in the first, two for the Kings, one for Philadelphia, and the second, two for Philadelphia. Flyers Dvorak, along with Marsh, shoot at the center. Evans back there is with Ben Wilson on the right, Mark Taylor centering. Korab on the defense with Hardy, and again it's Kelly, Ruskowski, and Fox for the Kings. Up the slot, Ruskowski. The Flyers have three men back at the Flyer line, tries to lift it in. Blocked off by Mark Taylor, shot to center ice with 20 seconds left. Whistled in by the Kings, they all pursue. In there is Brad Marsh up along the near side to Evans. Takes a bump from Ruskowski, but still clears to Taylor at center with 10 seconds remaining in the period. Taylor flips offensive right corner. Kings have it behind the net. In the corner, they try to roll it out. We're going to come to the end of the second period with the puck in the Los Angeles zone. Two periods of play gone from the Forum in Inglewood, California. Krupp from Sittler is 25th at 14:09 of the first period on the power play. 1:18 of the second. McCrimmon is second from Bathe and Allison. Flyers had both penalties in the second period, three of the game's five. The penalties, the shots were 11 apiece in the second, 24:18 for Philadelphia for the game. 2-0 Flyers after 40 minutes as our intermission activities will commence after this.
Pawlatuck, the Arctic Circle. The wind.
Hi, we're back at the Forum in Inglewood, California, one of the multi-suburban communities that encompass one of the largest cities in square mileage in the world, Los Angeles. We're about, what, probably at about a 10-minute drive west of the beach, or east of the beach from the airport, right next to Hollywood Park. Beautiful building on the outside, but we really don't think you and I think it's that fabulous on the inside.
Gene, let me ask you something in your little book of trivia. Is this the first time that two European goalies have faced each other in the National Hockey League?
It might be because there have only been a couple before. Matson and Oran Augusta played with Colorado and...
Yeah, just briefly, in Quebec.
Yeah, Quebec. And it may well be.
Had Yuri Sira with the Toronto Maple Leafs as well.
Yeah, unless he played against Matson.
Or it might be.
All right, we're set for the third period. The referee, Ron Hogarth. The linesman, Ryan Bozek, and Dan Moronelli.
You can't say it easy.
Well, you know why? I had my paperclip over his name, Moronelli.
Sure.
I never blew him in a nota, though. Puck in the Flyer zone. Howe chased by J.T. Kelly. Lines it to the point. Carson tries to deflect it out. He's grabbed in there deep by Korab, who springs the puck free to the point. Then Ruskowski is checked at the line. Spins inside, is pulled down. We're going to get another Flyer penalty against Clark. And the Kings have come out with gusto in this period and forced that penalty. It comes at 23 seconds. Kings power play coming up. 2-0 Philadelphia.
You want something better. Healthy food is on your mind. Wendy's does it better. That's why you're Wendy's kind of people. You'll find our salad bar deliciously complete. 12 garden fresh ingredients, yeah. All you can eat. That's why you're Wendy's kind of people. You want something better. You're Wendy's kind of people.
Hawking's a call on Clark at the 23-second mark. This gives Los Angeles its fourth power play opportunity.
0 for 3 on the day, 0 for 9 against Philadelphia. The Kings will make their only Philadelphia appearance a week from tomorrow at the Spectrum. That'll be the Flyers' next game after their home return on Thursday against St. Louis. The Kings on the power play, cleared around, offensive right wing corner. Bathe is out there with Prop, Taylor, and McCrimmon. They go left side, pass intended in the corner for Dion, cleared but not away from the Kings, now taken by Prop. Scales, but not out, kept him at the point by Murphy. Then it's nice play by Mark Taylor as they went in deep to Dion. He poke checked it off his stick to Prop, and Prop sends it down. Kings have a minute 30 on the advantage. Dave back with McCrimmon, and again Taylor with Prop as bringing it up the middle unchallenged is Mark Hardy. Finds his man up the middle, Bernie Nichols. Tries to go in, he's got a man in front, Simmer! And it was deflected away to the near side and taken off by Philadelphia. And through it, center ice is Taylor. And to try to turn past Hardy into the near side where Prop takes it. Then he skated off by Larry Murphy. The puck behind the Philadelphia attack net. Taylor has it between his skates. He's got three Kings in there, and he won't let the puck go. He's got it jammed up against the board. Now in there is Paul Evans to break it free. He's behind the net. Marvelous work by Evans and Taylor. And finally, the Kings work it away. Taylor is brought back as Bernie Nichols brings it up the middle with Simmer on his left. Dion on his right. Dion pivots at the point. Checked by two men, and as Paul Evans does that check, the puck caroms off the stick into the seats far side.
One thing the Flyers are doing, they're really jumping on the puck carrier for Los Angeles and hurrying him into making a bad pass or at least passing it before he really wants to. And that can really make you play better defensively when you're jumping on that puck carrier. Dion, of course.
Evans to Dvorak, and he ices it, goes right in on Matson. They've got Evans back at the point along with Murphy and up front. Ruskowski with Fox and J.P. Kelly. They work left side to Evans at the Flyer line, wraps behind Lindbergh, sets it up for Marsh, steers it in the near corner away from Marsh. Three Kings, two Flyers in there. The Kings get it back to the point and splits the defense, and it goes all the way down.
Again, the Flyers getting that puck and then just getting it out through the middle.
15 seconds on the penalty. Evans along the near side in front, works past Billy Barber's check. Larry Murphy up at center ice at the flyer line, going to go up the middle, penetrates, swings to the right, goes around behind the net. Kelly then is grabbed off by McCrimmon. McCrimmon in there with Bay. They try to tie it up. The penalty is over. They work the puck on the far side. King's keeping it in the offensive corner. Two Kings, two Flyers in there. It's poked loose into the corner. McCrimmon then steers it to the point, and it's scooped through Larry Murphy and off the skate of Dan Morrowelli. Off to the near side where the Kings shoot it in the seats. Another power play going to Borning. And we have 17:20 remaining in the game. It remains 2-0 Philadelphia. Our next broadcast is next Thursday. That's the 10th of the month, 7:30 from the Spectrum against the St. Louis Blues.
Lindbergh didn't have to face a shot on that opportunity by the Kings. Again, the Flyers have really been clearing that front area and protecting the slot.
Prop, Flockhart, and Holmgren. The case counter with Evans and Hopkins with Doug Smith, the centerman. We've got Korab back with Jay Wells, who's retreats behind his net, swings it up on the left side to Evans, can't handle it. McCrimmon at the point, wraps it behind the net. Holmgren there, works away beautifully, looks for a man in front, but his pass for Mark Taylor hit the skate. Of a King defenseman clears to the near side. They give it back to the point, and it goes off McCrimmon to center ice. He goes nicely through to Holmgren over the line on the near side. Prop back to Holmgren. Trick shot in on Matson. Goes to the home position, makes the save, and then boom, Prop is just mugged behind the net as the Flyers try to work it out. Again, there's a situation where you dominate a team, and yet they have four power plays to your two, 10 to your four for the season. Is that an editorial comment? Now we get a hand pass, and the Flyers will get an offensive right circle faceoff. We have 16:35 remaining in the game, and it is 2-0 Philadelphia as we pause for station identification on the Flyers Hockey Network.
This is WTAF, TV 29 in Philadelphia.
I think that was a very sly editorial comment there, Gene.
Sittler, Barber, and Senesalo out with Cochran and Howe. And the Kings counter with Nichols, Isaacson, and Mike Murphy, along with Dean Kennedy and Mark Hardy. Puck at the flyer line. They try to get inside Howe. They do, but with no possession. And then, as Howe touches up and he's challenged on a poke check by Nichols, we get a delay offside.
Well, Barber will be happy to get back after this road trip because he'll get his jaw re-examined by the doctors in Philly. And good chance that those wires that wired it shut over the last couple of weeks could come off.
No more malted milks, huh?
And also be able to brush his teeth.
Puck at center. Flyers take it off. Cochran in, but Sittler is stopped by Dean Kennedy. And then as it comes back in, we have a delay offside. Finally whistled. 16:07 left in the game. 2-0 Philadelphia. Prop from Sittler is 25th and 14:09 first period power play. McCrimmon is second from Bay at 1:18 of the second. Just outside the Kings line, taken by Cochran at the blue line. Shoots a routiner in on Motson. Stops, sets it up behind for his defense. Dean Kennedy swings out up the middle. Pass is deflected away by Mike Murphy, and the Kings have to try again. Murphy gets it at center. Threw over the line. Nichols fakes the shot. Gets inside Cochran. He's there. Shot. Lindbergh takes the angle away beautifully as the Kings go back to the point. Dean Kennedy a shot. Grabbed eye high by Lindbergh as he goes to his knees with Murphy coming out of the corner.
Boy, he has those quick reflexes and hands, and I'll tell you, he just showed it right there.
We have 15:41 remaining in the game. 2-0 Philadelphia. With Bobby Taylor at the forum in Inglewood, California, 2-0 Flyers. As look out, there is a play back to the point. Kennedy, oh, Mark Hardy gets a screen right on, and Lindbergh, as if designed, kicks the deep rebound away from three men in front. As Clark back over the line against Kennedy, swings at the point, but we have an offside. Boy, he just, everything he does seems to be so planned and within the system.
Well, that's what Bernie has been working on this year with Pelle Lindbergh, and he has really responded well. A good low shot that Pelle Lindbergh had everybody in his doorstep, so he had to kick it past the players in front. And of course, Clark, Carson, and Allison were able to break away after that rebound.
Face off just outside the Kings line along their right wing side. Fox out along with Kelly and Roskowski with Kennedy and Mark Hardy. The Flyers go Clark, Carson, and Allison with Dvorak and Marge. Puck behind the Kings net, up along the near side. It's worked, but not out. So Kelly goes behind. Allison is bumped off by Mark Hardy. And then Hardy, in turn, has to get away from the check. And boom, he gets the screen check from Allison, but works around to his own left wing side. And it's cleared through Kelly and all the way down past Roskowski into the Flyers' corner, where it's played to Dvorak near side by Lindsey Carson. He has trouble. Kings take it away. Flyers take it back. All of this action now behind the Flyer goal. As Marsh gets it to Clark, he fails to get it out. The Kings roll it in the slot, but there is Lindsey Carson to pick it off and get it up through past Allison at center ice. Dave Lewis, the Kings captain, rolls right side in his own zone for Mike Murphy and up through to Roskowski at center ice. To Kelly. Kelly stopped at the line, then it's poked inadvertently back in by the puck stealer prop. Kings had a play, and then Philadelphia's Marsh says enough of that. Bounces it all the way down, and Monson makes the play to his right when it appeared it might have been a Philadelphia icing. Kings give it away. Now Holmgren overskated on the near side, but the Flyers bat it down behind the net. Holmgren is in there with Mike Murphy. Screens them off. They fight for it behind. Holmgren in front to prop. Prop is spun around. Holmgren digs it out. He's behind the net. Tries to go into the offensive corner. Screens it off for Mike Murphy to Bathe, and Bathe wraps it behind the net where Mattson gives it right away in front. The prop, the Flockhart shot. Oh, and Mattson makes a dandy. It's still loose in front. Cleared to the near side and sent all the way down by Charlie Simmer. That'll be an icing as Mattson came up with a $10 for him.
Boy, did he ever. I'll tell you, Flockhart was right there on an excellent setup from Prop, and Mattson keeps his team close on a big save. As Holmgren did an awful lot of work inside the Flyer zone, and then it came out to Flockhart, got a good wood on it, lots of time to shoot, but Mattson made that left pad save. Dan, don't forget that ticket pro, or the tickets for Thursday night's game against the St. Louis Blues. You can get them by phone, 215-665-8051, or the toll-free number 1-800-223-0120.
Offensive right circle faceoff for Philadelphia. Prop and Holmgren centered by Flockhart with Bathe and McCrimmon. And the Kings have the Dion line out there along with Bonner and Simmer. Dealing the outlet pass at center. Bathe through to Holmgren. Taps it deep along the offensive left wing boards into the corner where it's retrieved by Jay Wells. Makes a maneuver away on the far side to Bonner as Holmgren's doing some fierce checking now. Offensive left corner. Holmgren's going to be checked by Wells. Tries to protect the puck. He can't. Bonner can't dig it out. In there as well as Dion. And Dion is down. Goes Prop as he was stripped the play coming to center ice. Through at the Flyer line. Taken off by the Flyers and taken back in offside by Charlie Simmer.
Well, I'll tell you, Holmgren really took a run at Jay Wells, and they ran at each other the last time the Flyers were in here. Wells had set some real solid checks on the Flyers, and Holmgren got him a couple times as well, but Dion was able to make that break up through the center ice, but Bathe stood up at the blue line and forced Marcel Dion to make an extra move, and that forced the offside.
13:32 remaining in a scoreless third period. Flyers on top 2-0. They've got Evans left, Ben Wilson right, along with Mark Taylor, and Howe with Cochran, as Howe brings it up the middle. Fights his way past Korab, and we're going to have a penalty against Big Jerry. And he just put his head down and then raises his stick up in the air saying, why me? So the penalty's in the game now. 3 to the Kings of the 7 called by Ron Hogarth. The Flyers 1-for-2 on the power play will come up with their third pop.
While that speed of Mark Howe, as he went to the outside on Korab, Korab tried to slow him down, and Mark Howe probably helped things out a bit, too, as he went to the ice on that play. But nonetheless, I guess it's a hooking call on Jerry Korab, and it'll come at 6:36, and that'll give Philadelphia its third power play opportunity. They've had one in each period.
For Korab, 61 minutes on the year. Again, 3 of the 7 of the whistles belong to Los Angeles. We're 1-for-1 now, or 1-1 in this period. Each team has had a call. Flyers, as Bobby mentioned, are 1-for-2 on the advantage, and 1-for-4 against the Kings in the two games played here so far. Out there, they've got Ashton and Sittler with Prop and Sinisalo. At the point, they've got Howe and Dvorak. Kings get it out, as the Flyers really never got the play set up well offensively. Evans is out there with Roskowski. As the Flyers now working up on the right side to Sittler. Beautiful pass in full stride over the line. Up the middle. Right left wing corner pass for Prop. Broken up. Cinesalo takes it behind the net. Chopped that by Murphy. The puck kicks out to Prop. Prop back into the deep corner to Cinesalo. Gets a return pass back. He's double teamed. Roskowski is pulled down and now Prop is going to go off. And so that'll wipe out the last 83 seconds of the Flyer power play and give the Kings a 37-second advantage when Korob's penalty expires. We have 12:47 remaining in the game at the Forum in Inglewood, California. Flyers 2 and Kings nothing.
The airline that doesn't plan for the future may not have one. 5 years ago, Eastern saw the future in a remarkable aircraft. Now it's here. The new Boeing 757, the most advanced, most fuel-efficient commercial jet ever built. It's going to help Eastern hold down the cost of flying for years to come.
We earn our wings for you, that's why we're Eastern, America's favorite way.
Ron Hogarth has called 8 penalties, 4 of them for hooking, 3 of them for tripping. The lone penalty not out of that category was a slash on Holmgren, but Prop picks up the fourth hooking call at 7:13, and the power play goes by the way.
Prop now 58 penalty minutes in the air, 5 of the 8 penalties in Philadelphia. They'll play 5 aside for a minute 23. That's the time remaining on Los Angeles's Jerry Korap's time. Philadelphia goes Marsh and Dvorak along with Sittler and Barber, the Kings counter with Doug Smith, Mark Hardy, Jay Wells, and Roskowski, who's been a good addition, I guess, here for the Kings with all their troubles coming out of Chicago. Roskowski goes down as the puck rolls in front of the Philadelphia net. Brad Marsh bringing it to center for Sittler. Cut off nicely by Jay Wells. Tries to outlet through for Doug Smith. Coming through at the Flyer line. Over the line. Shoot! And not much of a shot that Lindbergh was able to gather in. And then Dvorak chased behind the net. Falls. Marsh as the puck poked loose to Roskowski out of that offensive right corner. Back to the point. There goes Jay Wells. Short out the side, right side of Pelle Lindbergh. And cleared back to the far point where the Flyers are cut off. There's another play back to the point. Lindbergh is shot in front. Rebound. In front again. They scramble for it. And it's poked away by Marsh. Sittler outlets in full flight for Barber down the left wing. He struggles after it. And Wells cuts him off in the offensive corner. Boom. Pokes the puck away behind the net as the Kings, Jay Wells and Mark Hardy, had a couple of good opportunities there. Here come the Kings on the far side. Dion is cut off. And Bade rips it to center ice. And Sittler there fights off the linesman, Dan Morielli. Gets it into the zone along the near side. Drops back to the near side. Looks to get it cross ice. Goes into the corner. Puts it in front for Paul Evans. His shot is a weak one on that. Steered back to the point. McCrimmon goes in deep off Sittler's glove. And the Kings finally control, roll at the center ice, as out comes Mark Taylor on with McCrimmon and Evans with Bave, with the Kings getting a man out of the box right now on the power play. Kings technically on their fifth power play, 0 for 4. There's a play in front to Taylor. Taylor works into the slot, shot wide to the left of Mattson, as the Kings have 25 seconds remaining on the advantage. Outletting off the stick of Evans to center ice, picked off by the Flyers. Taylor back and forth with McCrimmon, and they're booing here at the impotency of the Kings' power play. Flyers shoot it all the way down. Again, Taylor out with Evans, and now Dvorak with Marsh, as the Kings have 9 seconds left on the advantage. 10:55 in the game. They're back by a pair. There goes the play through to Bonner. His right circle shot is deflected behind the net by Marsh. Kings battle for it. The penalty is over. Dvorak kicks it free, works it up. Through on the left wing to center ice. The Prop coming out of the penalty box. Into the zone. Cross ice pass looking for winger Ray Allison. It deflects off the defenseman Jay Wells of the Kings. Plays at his own line behind Bonner, who has to go in and retreat. Then gives it away at center ice to Philadelphia's Marsh. He just drives it back behind Mattson. Into the near corner. Allison picks it off as Simmer had his back turned to the play. He's tied up in the corner. Comes out of the corner to Lindsey Carson. Boom. Down goes Jay Wells, and there's a lost glove as the Kings finally make the play up on the near side. Up through at center. Bonner on the left wing to Simmer. Again, that half stride he doesn't have anymore. Due to the broken leg, never a big skater, and he loses the puck. Flyers get it out. Now Korab rolls it in down the right side, but the Kings are cut off. Nobody in deep pursuit as they were making the line change, but then Marsh had it roll off the stick and given away by Dvorak on the backhander up through past Ulf Isaacson into center ice, and the Kings quickly drive it back in the corner to the left of Lindbergh. Wound around to Allison on the near side by Marsh. Then Marsh through to Allison at center ice, trying to find Bobby Clark. The Kings pick it off. Korab is stopped. Now Isaacson tries to go through on the near side. There goes Nichols in front. Shot. Oh, and Lindbergh got a piece of that as he came out to take the net away. Now the Kings working offensive left corner. Two Flyers, two Kings, and Ron Hogarth stops play as the penalty has expired. The team's at full strength. 9:30 remaining in a scoreless third period. 2-0 Philadelphia.
Hey, remember, don't mix the next Flyers Youth Hockey Clinic. Ben Wilson, Ilka Sinisalo, and Jimmy Watson will be at the Tarkin Rink in Northeast Philadelphia on Tuesday, February the 15th, from 3:30 to 5:30. If you want more information on this clinic, call the Flyers at 215-465-4500.
Lockhart, Propp, and Holmgren out, along with Howe and Cochran, and the Kings go Nichols with Ulf Isaacson, Mike Murphy. They've got Mark Hardy out with Larry Murphy. Kings get it along the near side. Shot by Mike Murphy is deflected wide of the net to the Flyer left wing corner and played off the stick of Mark Hardy in the center ice by Propp. Shot in over the top of Pelle Lindbergh's outstretched reach. The Flyers wind it around. Cochran through to Propp, and he sends it all the way down. It'll be wide of the goal mouth. We'll have an icing called as Mark Hardy in first to touch up for the Kings. 9:07 remaining in the game. Flyers 2, Kings nothing.
Kings defense are starting to pinch in a little more here in the latter stages of the third period. That's making it difficult for the Flyers to come out along the boards. Mark Hardy, along with Jay Wells, came up at the same time, and there were two young defensemen who the Kings really put an awful lot of hopes on. I think you'd have to talk to the coaching staff and the management, just see how much they think or feel of their progress.
Sidler, Barber, Sinisalo with Bathe and McCrimmon, and the Kings have Ruskowski out with Kelly and Fox defensively. Larry Murphy with Dave Lewis. Puck shot to center. Lewis and Murphy retreat to the Kings line. Now they play left wing to J.P. Kelly, and J.P. sends it right back past Lindbergh. Rolls into the Flyers' defensive left wing corner. Down goes Kelly as he's checked by Sittler. Puts it in front. Murphy with a shot. Blocked off the pad of Lindbergh. It goes wide on the rebound. Look out for a stuffer on the near side. The Kings putting on some heat now as they're back by two, and time's a-wasting. And finally, Sittler is able to pull it off. Through to Sinisalo, in on a breakaway. Right out in front. Shot. Save. Rebound shot over the top of the net by Billy Barber. Boy, right there, Marcus Mattsson saves the game for the Kings, keeps them within two. That's still a tenuous lead for Philadelphia. And here comes Ruskowski. Let's see if the Kings can come back. Over the line. Bathe whistling orders. There's Ruskowski in front and unable to handle the puck as Fox. Centering pass block. Right back in front to Murphy, a drive. That's blocked by Bathe. And set up through on the left wing to Sinisalo. He'll go one-on-one over the line with Jay Wells. Up the middle. Left circle shot off the stick of Wells up into the end seats. By Marcus Mattsson with a marvelous save. With 8:06 remaining in the game. From the Forum in Inglewood, California, Flyers 2 and the Kings nothing.
Toyota Supra challenged Pikes Peak. This road has been challenging Kara since 1916.
And sometimes it wins.
The Peak has curves that challenge Supra's independent suspension and rack and pinion steering.
Holds the road better than some race cars.
Inclines push the Supra's electronically fuel-injected twin cam 6, the 1983 Toyota Celica Supra. It takes the right stuff to challenge the Peak.
And this is the right stuff.
Mattsson has made two big saves for Los Angeles to keep this game at 2-0 Philadelphia, especially off that breakaway by Sinisalo. Barber's rebound attempt was shot over top of the net, but he robbed Flockhart earlier in the period as he was all alone in front as well.
Kings out shooting the Flyers in this period. The tune of 8-4. Philadelphia has the margin for the game, 30-25. Now Darrell Evans coming up through to Dean Hopkins at the Flyer line against Marsh. Swings way wide to his right, shoots in on Lindbergh. It seemed to fool him, put him in the five-hole area. The pads fell at his feet, and he grabbed the rebound.
Didn't really get enough of the shot on him, as the shot was just quickly tried to go the outside Hopkins, but he got and appeared to be really rolling on Kelly Lindbergh and handcuffed him somewhat, but he was able to control that rebound and force the faceoff. And that's the most important thing when it does fool you, to know where that puck's going to go and then hope that the rebound doesn't go far enough, or at least control the rebound so it doesn't go far enough.
Smith, Hopkins, and Evans for the Kings, with Korab and Wells, the Flyers, with the defensive left circle faceoff at Mark Taylor on, with Wilson and Evans, and now as Taylor is dumped out of the circle along with Doug Smith, it'll be Hopkins. Defensive left circle faceoff. The Philadelphia 2, proper power play goal in the first, McCrimmon in the first 2 minutes of the second, and that's been it. Puck dropped back to the point, and it got right through Korab, and there's a foot race as Korab, slow of foot, goes into the corner to the right of his net, as a nice job by Wells cutting off the Flyer pursuit, and Dvorak on the near side couldn't contain the puck as the Flyers did come to center ice and played by Marsh, blue line to blue line, where the Kings control again. Korab out with Wells, and they've got Hopkins on with Evans and Smith. Now Smith through at the Flyer line, long shot off Lindbergh's pad, and Ben Wilson inexplicably just turns around and ices it. Mike Murphy, Larry Murphy touches up. 7:26 remaining in the game, 2-0 Philadelphia. All-star game to be seen locally. Check your newspaper for station and time at 8 o'clock on Tuesday. It'll be Channel 29, I believe, at 8 o'clock. And then the Flyers back home on the radio network next Thursday at 7:30 with St. Louis.
That was probably one of the few times the Flyers didn't really have some poise and just fired it away when they didn't have to do that.
I don't think that All-Star game's on 2019.
No, I just stand corrected. Local cable networks, again, check your newspaper for a time and what channel station. Flyers with a puck behind the net. The Kings putting on a lot of heat right now, and well, they have to. They're back by a pair. At times they're wasting. 7:15 left in the game. They've picked up 10 shots now in this period, 27 for the game. There's a lead against Simmer. Slow of pace is beaten with the puck by Mark Howe around behind the net, but he's able to catch up to Howe and stick check him off the puck. Clark tries to dig it out and does, and lifts it out of his own left wing corner high in the air, a la Borja Salming style, and bounces into the King zone. Mark Hardy out there along with Mary Murphy, and a giveaway pass at center off the stick of Cochran in front of the Philadelphia net, where Howe has it, drives it off the glass to center, and it rolls all the way through the King defense to the left of Mattson over the goal line. Play will continue. Hardy goes behind the net. Larry Murphy's pass is blocked off by Philadelphia's Lindsey Carson. Clark in there, but the Kings are able to slide it to center ice with 6:34 remaining in the game. 2-0 Philadelphia. There's a pop fly by Clark, and it bounced in short. Hop on Mattson, rolled off the pad to his right. No threat of going in, but still got some ooze here at the forum. 14,146. Kings come to the Flyer line, dump it in after it is propped. Comes back to the strong side with the Kings. Isaacson loses it to Holmgren and up through to Flockhart at center ice. Weaves through one man, can't get through for a second. The puck comes in after him. The Kings take it off and shoot at the center ice. Knocked down on the high stick and then controlled by Flockhart for the violation. Stoppage of play at center ice with 6:05 remaining in the game. The Flyers 2, Los Angeles nothing.
Born of tradition, nurtured by pride. Budweiser Light, with a clean, distinctive taste. A light beer worthy of the king of beers.
Bring out your best. Bring out your best.
The best never comes easy.
Budweiser Light.
That's why there's nothing else like it.
Play out in the forum in Los Angeles, 5:45 remaining in the game, 2-0 Philadelphia. Behind their net, Wells quickly to Ulf Isaacson, coming out with Bonner, and Bernie Nichols rolled the puck in the Flyer zone, and Frank Babe is there to send it up through and all the way down the ice. I guess we'll have an icing call on Philadelphia, and both teams will be able to change lines at leisure with 5:28 remaining, 2-0 Philadelphia.
Well, they've really dropped back quite a bit, the Flyers. They have not forced the issue at all inside the Los Angeles zone. McCammon looking on rather nervously, as that next goal is an important one.
We had conversation with two well-known Philadelphians who've made their mark at Washington State. Former Villanovan George Raveling, who was in our hotel with his Washington State State Club, who played UCLA and USC this week. And Ron Ryder out of St. Joe's, who's George's assistant. They both send their best back to Philadelphia. Flyers win the draw. Sinisalo on the near side has a clear outlet if he wants it, and does to Dvorak up the middle. Rolling puck, and he rolls it into the offensive right corner. Sinisalo cut off by Roskowski as Mattson puts the puck on the stick of Paige P. Kelly, then puts it right out in front of his net. And a good thing that the Kings had somebody there. 5 minutes now remaining in the game as we play cat and mouse. The Flyers just holding off the Kings. Shot all the way down. We'll have an icing against Los Angeles, and Sittler will be the first in with the puck behind the Philadelphia net.
Roskowski tried to draw another penalty as Brad Marsh had him cut up through the middle, and he went to the ice just as the puck got there. But I'm not sure Hogarth saw it, or else he knew well what was on his mind.
Power plays in the two games in this building, Kings 11, Flyers 5. Barber and Sinisalo out with Marsh and Dvorak and the Kings. Oh, Ruskowski, Kelly, and Fox. Defensively, they have Mark Hardy on with Larry Murphy. Flyers win the draw back to Dvorak. Looks to the net, doesn't shoot, winds it around behind to the offensive left boards, but Jim Fox is there for the Kings, cut off by Sittler. Tries to roll it through, Flyers keep it in. Kings control, though, as it's played by Murphy in front of his net. Gets a return pass to Mark Hardy, and Larry Murphy brings it up the middle. At the Flyer line, broken up by Dvorak. Dvorak at center, loses the puck near side. J.P. Kelly penetrates, wraps it behind Kelly Lindbergh, a wraparound to the far side. Barber has it, takes it away from Ruskowski, clears it to the near corner. In there is Dvorak along with Sinisalo. The Kings dump it behind the net. Marsh, a good play. It comes out in front. Look out, Larry Murphy, a drive! Wide of Lindbergh as he came way out, 8 feet in front. The block off the angle. Kings Ruskowski gets the puck, offensive corner. Back to the point. Lifted into the offensive left wing corner as Mark Hardy had no shot. And then the Kings give it away to Marsh. Marsh out to the point. Kept in, put into the slot. But cut off by Dvorak. Flyers now hanging a bit as the Kings putting on extra adrenaline with just 3:58 remaining in the game. They get a standoff behind the Flyer net. Philadelphia 2 and the Kings nothing.
Haviland Supreme Motor Oil. Up front, its protective additives help save wear and tear on your engine, and in back, its special friction fighter helps save on gasoline. It takes proven upfront engine protection backed by improved gasoline economy and puts them all together.
Get a knit hat free with a Haviland oil change, filter, and lube. Get a matching scarf at a special price. Good only until February 28th at your participating independent Texaco retailer. 3:58 remaining in the game at the Forum in Inglewood, California. 2-0 Philadelphia. There's a play into the slot shot over the top of the net off the stick of Darrell Evans. Into the Flyers' defensive left wing corner where Cochran is cut off. Dean Hopkins behind the net is bumped by Clark, tries to put it in front. Cochran takes it out to Lindsey Carson and away to Allison at center ice. He's cut off, and what do we got here?
Cochran's going to get a slashing call from Ron Hogarth.
Very bad penalty at the wrong time. There's 3:43 left in the game. You're controlling a 2-0 lead, and you give the club their sixth power play of the game.
Well, Los Angeles has not been very successful on that man advantage this afternoon, but as you mentioned, this is their sixth power play opportunity, and you keep getting those chances, and they're bound to start clicking, or at least getting a bounce for them, but Parkin picks the penalty up. And it comes at 16-17. Flashing's the call.
He has 155 minutes now on the year. Flyers have had three of this third period's four penalties. They have six of the game's nine. Kings are 0-for-5 on the afternoon. They are 0-for-11 in the two games against Philadelphia.
Cochran and Smith were fighting in the corner, going for possession of the puck, and Smith had lost his stick. And it was just after that that Cochran gave him a slash in the eyes of Ron Hogarth and picked up that penalty.
Well, if the Kings can get one now, the last couple of minutes will be Brimmen Firestone there. Remember last year, they went into the last minute of play down 4-2. Got a power play goal by Dion, and then one into the net by Larry Murphy. There's a play behind. Look out. It's played back to the point to Hardy. Right side to Murphy. Got Dion in the near circle. They go behind the net to Nichols. He's cut off. Tries to center. He's got Dion in the near corner. Checked by McCrimmon. Jammed up against the board. In comes Howe with Dion. The four of them fight for it. It spins to the near side, and Philadelphia's defenseman McCrimmon, I think, accidentally on purpose fell on the puck to get the stoppage. Flyers will have a defensive right circle faceoff with 3:13 remaining in the game. 1:30 on the penalty to Glenn Cochran, 2-0. Philadelphia. Shots in this period, the Flyers have had but four, and the Kings have had 10, cutting Philadelphia's margin down after the two periods, which was at 9, now down to 3:30, Philadelphia 27 for Los Angeles. All right, Flyers go Clark and Howe with Bathe and McCrimmon. The Kings have Nichols on the right. Simmer will take the draw. Dion on the left with Hardy and Larry Murphy. Defensive right circle faceoff, Clark against Simmer. Puck is dropped. It's kicked off to the near side. Dion tries to get it back to the point. Tied up by Clark. All along the Flyers' defensive right boards, about halfway out of the corner. And again, we get another standoff. As in there was McCrimmon and Clark, along with Simmer and Dion. Goal scorer's prop at 14:09 to the first period is 25th from Sittler on the power play. McCrimmon is second from Bathe at 1:18 of the second, and that's been it since. Now it'll be Nichols against Clark with a face-off in the Flyers' defensive right-wing circle between the dot and the top of the arc of the circle. Handled by Dan Moriella. Back to the point. Hardy looks, loses, drives, and it's deflected way wide of Lindbergh's left. Nichols goes back to the left point. Murphy cuts up the middle. Left side to Hardy. They've got an open man on the far side. Nichols, Dion shot. And he tried to get Simmers' tap in front, but it was cut off by Philadelphia. And then Clark up along his own right wing side, and the deflection sends it all the way down. We have a minute remaining on Cochran's penalty. 2:40 left in the game. 2-0 Philadelphia. The Kings at center. Nichols lifts it into the offensive left corner. Dvorak in there. Spins around to the left side of Lindbergh. Slashes at the puck and sends it all the way down. Marsh and Dvorak out now with Taylor and Propp. And it is Murphy back with Hardy. And up front, Nichols with Dion and Simmer. Kings now. Time's a waste, and they're back by two. Come to the center ice. Nichols is checked by Mark Taylor. Dumps it into the offensive corner again. Dvorak is in there. Cut off by Simmer. Taylor gets it off into the slot shot. Lindbergh to save it. Bounces behind him. And into the net goes Lindbergh. And out of the net comes Dvorak to send it through to Taylor at center ice. 2-on-1. Dvorak and Taylor. Dvorak to Taylor. In shot. Marcus Mattsson makes a dandy save. With 15 seconds on the advantage. The Kings to Dion at center ice. Picked up on the left side to Darrell Evans. His shot blocked. Gets the rebound. Into the corner. Skated off by Taylor. It goes to Korab at the point. Point shot. That hit the King diving in front. J.P. Kelly, as he tried to get it away, it hit him, and out of the penalty box comes Cochran with a minute 40 left in the game. And for the second straight game, the Kings have gone 0-for-6 against the Flyers in this building on the power play. Two-line pass coming out of the King zone. We get a with a minute 33 left, the penalty box is empty. 2-0 Philadelphia. Don't forget to stay tuned at the early evening hour, 7:30 in Philadelphia, for the Pepsi post-game show coming up after the final buzzer. Felly Lindbergh, stoically in the net, has not played since the Russian game on January 6th, has not played in a league game since January 4th at the Spectrum, when he held Vancouver at 4-1. And in that game, the goal by Vancouver came in the last half minute off the stick of a former Flyer, Kevin McCarthy. Ruskowski has been an effective forward today for the Kings, out with Fox on the right and Kelly on the left. A hustling line. Of course, Ruskowski coming to Chicago along with Rich Preston from Winnipeg. Now up the middle, there's Frank Bay then, a weak backhander, steered to the left by Mattsson. The Flyers quickly get back as Sittler is out with Barber and Sinisalo. Shot by Sittler is wide, back to the left point to Frank Bay. He bangs it behind the King's net. It rolls to the Flyer offensive right side. Sinisalo in there with J.P. Kelly, who bounces it to the blue line, and McCrimmon contains and drives it back behind the King goal. 1:10 remaining in the game, 2-0 Philadelphia. An outlet pass blocked into the zone. Sinisalo into the right wing corner is cut off, and the Kings work it up on the right wing at center ice, but a pass is missed by Fox as Mattsson tried to come out of the goal. He fell down, and there was a little huzzah there as the Kings with the extra forward. McCrimmon has the puck come to center ice. Now Fox waits for it to clear, and then it's Bernie Nichols driving it in behind. 47 seconds left, 2-0 Philadelphia. The Flyers try to get it out. Where is it? And it bounced high in the air, and it was behind Mark Hardy at center, but Sinisalo was behind him for the break, didn't see it. Now Hardy penetrates, flips into the offensive left wing corner. McCrimmon behind the net on a wraparound to the blue line. It bounced, is kept in, flipped by Larry Murphy. It hits Frank Babe. He chips it to Barber at center ice. The Kings take it away. O'Cross on the near side and taken in by J.P. Kelly. Kelly in the corner, shot on the net, short side save by Lindbergh, and it had an open corner. Oh my, with 16 seconds left in the game, the Flyers shoot it toward the open net. It's going to miss it. And we'll get an icing call right now with 7 seconds left in the game. We'd like to thank the following people who helped bring you this radio telecast. Producer Mike Pinocchiero, director Doug Freeman from Los Angeles. Thank you, Doug. Our assistant director, Leslie Jackman. Our studio coordinators back in Philadelphia, George Cummings and Ray Lombardi. Well, the Kings had a short side tip that appeared to have a little opening room against Lindbergh, and it stayed away. And the Kings, with that barrage, now have 31 shots in the game, and it is the first time that the Flyers have given up more than 29 shots in any game since December 26th at Washington, when they won by the count of 6-3. Now, let's see how long is that. Well, that game was the Flyers' 36th. This is their 54th. It's been 18 games since the Flyers have given up the 30 mark in shots. 7 seconds left. Offensive left circle faceoff. The Kings have 6 players out there. The Flyers have Clark, Propp, along with Marsh, Dvorak, and Holmgren. Clark gets the draw in his own left wing, in his own right wing corner. Flyers can wrap around, and that would be it. Puck is dropped. It goes in front, and Marsh is right there to pick it off. We have a false draw. We'll try again with 6 seconds remaining in the game. So the Flyers are not only trying for a sweep in Los Angeles this year, but a whitewash sweep. Now Clark again against Dion. Murray Elliott, the linesman, handle it, rolls to the slot. They whack at it, goes to the far side. Philadelphia works it into the corner. 2 seconds, 1 second, the game is over. And Pelle Lindbergh shuts out the Los Angeles Kings for his third shutout of the year. The Flyers' fifth, his second in a row at the Forum. Final, the Flyers 2, the Kings nothing. Stay tuned for the Pepsi post-game show coming up next.
This has been...